Anybody? Am I solo today?
Good afternoon.
No Morales to lead off the show?
I know.
There's an open in there, but there was like 20 seconds of nothing. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Uh-oh. Play it again.
Yeah, try it again. Let's see.
The final stop of that long road trip. Dodgers sweep the Giants, and Ohtani, the first home run. What's the strikeout tracker at, though? Just check it. Don't say that.
Oh, it's
meanwhile,
so stupid.
Ramona Shelburne's in for Johnny I, who will return tomorrow. Now, of course, tomorrow, Mace begins his spring break. Nothing like a nearly 60-year-old man taking spring break. Anyway, I digress. Because, of course, we will find out tomorrow. Will Ireland be sitting in the A chair or the B chair? Been a lot of conversation this week. And yes, Corporate Greg and I know how to create a bit out of nothing. That's for sure. A chair or B chair?
Oh.
By the way, Ramona should be in the A chair today. Let's hear Mason in the B. Why not?
Oh, bring it on.
It's spring break time.
Yeah.
Anything goes.
When I'm gone, what Bergman and Morales want is for Ireland to stay as the B and let somebody else lead the show, which I think is because Ireland's name is actually on the show. He should be the A. So I am sticking up for John, my friend, my partner. He should be the A.
Let's get to it. Celebrating their 20th year at ESPN Los Angeles, Mason in Ireland, Momo Edition. Your Thursday afternoon right now.
Good afternoon.
Now
it's a normal show.
God, that was a lot of shade thrown.
Let's do this.
Let's
at
do what?
At what point does Momo switch to the A chair?
Yeah, at what point, Momo?
I am so not prepared.
At what point
for
do you want the A?
I don't think you need to be prepared.
Yeah, you kind of do.
Yeah, you do. You're right. But
you
no, I think you can do it.
I mean, if there was like a big prep doc, you could just hand me.
Oh, no, we know.
A prep doc is in my head.
Yeah, no, I don't. We stopped making
like,
prep
when
docs.
I do, when I do the Sedano show, Lindsay yeah. Fulton hands
I know
me
she has this detailed.
This whole doc, yeah. And it's got links to it and stuff. I mean, it's just.
Yeah,
so
no.
If I handed you,
just
you a
show
doc.
Up, yeah.
If I handed you a doc with links on it, what would you do with it?
If you print it out.
I know what
finger,
you do. The 2 o'clock hour.
Right. Yay, Momo in the 2
Momo
o'clock hour.
Momo in the 2 o'clock
you
hour.
If
take
you
it
give
on.
Me some prep, I'll do it.
No, yeah. you're on your, you just can, roll.
So you'll start off with 2 o'clock call of the day. You'll
2 like, o'clock call of the day, which always that. Sucks.
And then
you just love springing this on me. You love it.
Well, Morales technically did it.
He did it, and now we have to do
Gosh.
It.
Right.
We'll go into the breaks, and we'll talk about, okay, let's do this next segment, and then we'll go from there.
By the way, tomorrow, Ireland is 1,000% in the A chair. 1,000% the one.
And Andy Kamenetsky.
1,000% Ireland's
so
going to lead.
Let me, so I can, as the person who often
yes,
hosts
is.
With John Ireland
yes, that's
when
right.
you are not here.
Yep.
You didn't ask me about tomorrow. I don't know what happened.
Because you you're doing Monday and Wednesday next week.
Just, no.
I'm just you were trying to give me hell, but
no,
I did.
The so when you host with John Ireland, he's the A.
Correct.
It's like the easiest job ever.
Meaning?
Like he just has... He has a prep doc.
Right.
I mean,
he does a very different.
It is very well prepared. It
it's
is like extensive.
1:15, this story, this
yes.
story. 1:30, this story, this story.
And if it's on that doc,
he's going to do it.
He's
yes.
going to do it in that segment.
Correct.
No
and
matter
if you
what.
Mess with him a little bit, like sometimes I try to mess with him because I know he's like, I want to get to the next story that I have slotted for 1:15.
Yeah.
I kind of mess with him a little bit, and you can tell he's getting a little flustered. Like,
yeah.
All right, let me get to this one.
But you want to talk about being anal. John is anal.
He just texted me yesterday saying, can you do the game for next Wednesday?
Right. No, he's already because next week is the next week.
He's probably, I'm about to get on the flight home.
Is Momo doing
DC.
The game today?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got some?
Yeah, it's weird.
Oh,
I couldn't
boy.
Think of any. I mean, I was in a weird place. I started off with one thing.
Yeah.
I was watching The Regime last night.
You know what? I am behind on The Regime, but I think it's a
that?
Hilarious
It's pretty good.
Show.
Yeah, I'm into it. I think I'm in episode 3 or 4. So
Kate Winslet is on. It's Kate Winslet, Matthijs Schoenaerts,
yeah.
and she is this dictator in some unnamed European
Central
country.
Central European country.
Who is afraid of mold. And so right. she has a guy following around all the time with a mold detector.
Yeah.
What's it on?
It's on HBO.
HBO? It's funny?
Oh, my God. It makes me laugh a lot.
It's like Michael Thompson sounds like.
Oh, it does. Yeah, it's very, very cleanly. Cleanly.
It's really, it's a good show, and I was watching it, and then my first attempt at the game was facts about Central European countries.
Oh, that's interesting.
I would have done that. I tried that's but not there was bad. Just a lot of Turkmenistan and
what'd you wind up with?
So I finished with, thank you.
Wound up with.
Something on people who have transformed their bodies like you're trying to do.
Nice. By the way, I'm so sore.
The first few days are just
intense. I did my second training last night.
Yeah.
It was leg day.
Oh.
And I'm already feeling it.
Yeah.
I don't think I'll be able to walk.
You need to start going to cryo.
You know, here's I've got all that going on. Then I'm getting a colonoscopy tomorrow on top of everything else.
Well, you'll just lay there.
The prep for the colonoscopy is the worst.
You don't have to move in the middle of the colonoscopy.
No, but the prep is like stay near the bathroom.
Yeah, yeah,
if you're laying down on the table, you don't have to move.
The colonoscopy itself is easy. Oh, they just knock you out and they go.
Do you get knocked out? I thought you don't.
No, you get knocked out. Oh yeah,
it's pretty intense.
As somebody said, like one of the best sleeps you'll ever have.
Yeah.
The problem is you got to drink 64 ounces of Gatorade with that stuff in it tonight.
Yeah, it's gross.
And you're not allowed to drink the red Gatorade. So I got the blue Gatorade. It's called Blue Ice, and I haven't tried it yet. But
why do you have to have Gatorade? Why can't you just do it with water?
I'm just following the instructions.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
The electrolytes?
Maybe that's it. But what flavor is Blue Ice? I've not opened this yet. Is it like a berry flavor? Is it like an ice? What is Blue Ice as a flavor with Gatorade?
I think it's like Gatorade? A blue raspberry.
Yeah, like you a think blueberry. It's
blueberry maybe. Kind of thing?
I just thought it was really, really cold ice.
Really cold
Arctic
ice.
Arctic ice, I think that's what it's called.
Yeah. By the way, speaking of ice, I'm just rambling here. Speaking of ice.
It's Mason Island. That's what we do.
We go last night to this great restaurant. Damn, I'm trying to think of the name of it.
You go to restaurants during the week.
Yeah.
On a school night. Okay.
Yeah, my mom, my aunt Linda were in town, my not stepdad Leo, so we went down to the beach. We went to where I used to live, right there, Navy Street at the beach.
Oh, I love that apartment.
It was such a good spot.
Yeah.
First time I've been back in 10 years.
Yeah.
So went took him back there, and we went to this restaurant, and I got a drink, a bourbon drink, and it had one gigantic round ice cube in it.
Now, I like those.
Have you seen this? Why is it important to have a gigantic round or square ice cube in your drink?
It just looks cool.
Exactly.
No, that's absolutely
think it just looks cool.
No, what it does is that it doesn't. You're getting it. You're putting it in your bourbon, so you're having it neat, but with that big ice cube.
Yes,
it slowly melts so that it's just not water.
Right.
It keeps it cold without it, just a little tiny bit of water getting into it to soften it a little bit.
But what's the difference between one big one and like
small ones melt faster.
Exactly. Those things melt
and then you dilute your bourbon.
You have a watery bourbon. That's why they do the big ones, so it's a slow drip.
Boy, that bourbon went down fast last night.
It's so good. Bourbon is delicious.
Wait, you did that after leg day?
I did that after leg day.
That's probably why you're super sore.
Yeah. Yeah.
Next time, go to cryo.
Leg day.
Or use the Ice Bot Active.
Then bourbon.
One of those two things doesn't seem right, does it, Momo?
Right.
Like the bourbon is not real or the leg day is not real.
Oh, no. The leg day happened right after the show, and then the bourbon was right after.
Okay. So you went from leg day to this place.
Correct. To this place. And I met my mom and not stepdad Lear.
And then,
what are you playing that for?
Yes,
and then
Brian.
You drank 64 ounces of Blue Ice.
No, that's tonight.
Well, that's tonight.
Tonight, the preparation.
Yeah, you can't have any bourbon before you do that.
No. By the way, everybody should get their colonoscopy.
Yeah, it's important.
Have you had one?
No, I'm not old enough yet.
You're not old? Yeah.
What is the age?
I guess it's 50 now.
50?
I heard they were thinking of moving it to 45.
50 and then every 7 years, I think, is what it is. Something like that. But I don't.
I've had a mammogram.
I'm not excited about it. Not excited about it.
Definitely get a mammogram if you're a lady listening. Do that.
There you go. This is our public health announcements. Yeah. Get a mammogram and a colonoscopy, and you'll be fine.
All the fun things.
You know, it's funny, Bergman. Momo pointed out to me that there were people in the Mason Ireland Mafia just killing your read of ZipRecruiter.
No, I know.
From yesterday.
Ready?
I killed
Makes
my read.
Makes you realize how good L.A. Ireland is at his job after hearing corporate Greg read that ZipRecruiter promo.
I did.
Another one. I think you should just run the John Ireland read of ZipRecruiter instead of Greg. They just lost several subscriber cues in your read. Jeez, corporate Greg, that read. Ah!
Okay, now Momo, I'm going to fully admit to you.
Yeah.
It was awful. When I finished the read, I said, that was awful.
Yeah, you did finish with that was awful. Right. Now, I believe in redemption.
I
believe in second chances.
You're such a jerk.
I believe that Greg Bergman today is going to do the ZipRecruiter, he is going to nail it. Will stick that effing landing.
You want me to tell you why I think I did a poor job of it? Because we talked about it the last time I did it, and I rushed through it really fast.
Right.
So I was trying to slow down, and I was thinking about slowing down. So then I just, for some reason, couldn't finish reading it because I was focusing on slowing down.
Yeah. You read things way too fast.
I talk way too fast.
You talk way too fast.
That's just that's who I am and how what I do.
Well, slow down what when I you do the ZipRecruiter today.
I'll try.
Yeah. You know what you have to you know what I do now that makes me not suck as bad? Is
just not suck next time.
Right. Just try not to. Is I actually just I pretend like I'm acting. I just will try to make them not suck next time.
Yeah. See, but
so
you
like I get out of myself. I said this is not Ramona doing it.
So you're acting?
I'm acting. I am a different person doing this read.
Wow.
This is not Momo doing the read. This is I get out of myself.
Interesting.
And I get into it like I'm really connecting to this material now.
You
like
do improv. Not. You're really connecting to the ZipRecruiter copy?
Did you know it can take up to 11 weeks on average to hire for an open position? That's almost 2.5 months, Mace.
See, there you go.
Did you know that?
If
you're trying to grow your business, you don't have 2.5 months to hire somebody.
But you know, this was a hard read. Like, you've had trouble.
It is hard. It is a very clunky read.
It's a long one.
It's long, too.
And there's
a
lot of ZipRecruiter.
Again, yes, that's ZipRecruiter.com/LA.
Okay, this is not even the time for it.
I know,
but
I'm just saying this is how you get
that
in.
That counted as it. Brian, write it down. That counted as it.
There you go. So last night, Dodgers win, Lakers win. The world is a great place today.
I thought for sure the Lakers were going to blow that one.
Boy, I'll tell you, when it dripped away, I was like, oh, my God. And then LeBron, AD, those guys come back in, finish it up. Yeah.
Because, everyone is winning. Like
everybody in front of them is winning.
And everyone behind them is winning.
Yeah.
Like you just have to keep winning. There's no wiggle room anymore. There's no, oops, it's the last game of a road trip. Like the Kings are winning. The Suns won last night.
Yep.
They beat the Cavs.
The Warriors have won five in a row.
Winning. Like it's like everyone is winning. And you look like last night I was watching some of the Suns Cavs game.
Right.
And I looked at their record.
Lakers get the Cavs next, by the way.
Yeah. On Saturday. Their records are very similar, and yet the Cavs are like third in the East, and the Suns are in the play-in.
Yeah, the East is terrible.
Yeah.
The East is... I think the Lakers are 11 games over 500, and they're the 9.
And then 9.
And I think 10 games under 500 gets you the 9 in the East.
Yeah, although 7 and 8 are still pretty good. The East goes 8 deep, and the West goes 11 deep.
You think that much?
Yeah. If you look at 7 and 8, it's the Heat and the Sixers, and their records are pretty good.
Yeah, the Heat. Yeah, you're right. The Heat are. Yeah, it's just those last spots.
Yeah.
Chicago and Atlanta. Chicago and Atlanta.
I know they have no business being.
Oh, it's terrible. Terrible.
Like it should just be like the regular 8 that they had before.
I think in the end it looks like it will turn out to be the regular 8. I can't imagine Chicago or Atlanta.
Yeah, I can't either, but Atlanta beat the Celtics twice recently.
Yeah, true.
You know, Chicago can win on any given night. I don't think so, but just making Miami and Philly have to jump through more hoops.
All right, let's get a quick break, and we're going to do some Dodgers coming up next. What are you pointing at?
You have a read. I don't know what it is. Jacob.
Oh, Jacob, yeah. And also, by the way, 6 signs you're in a bad restaurant.
Oh.
That's coming up, too.
I like that.
In the meantime, if you are injured in an accident, watch me embody this. Watch me.
Can you get into character?
I'm in character now. You've been through a traumatic experience. Your body is trying to recover. Your mind is racing. You need to see a doctor. A lot of long, confusing phone calls and eventually medical bills and more headaches. So if you're injured in an accident, just remember to call Jacob. Instead of dealing with everything yourself, make one call to Jacob. Let him handle the rest. Jacob will guide you through the process. And on top of all that, he'll also fight to get you the settlement that you deserve. You should take it easy. Do not stress. Let Jacob deal with the rest. Remember, a lot of attorneys say they'll fight for you. Call Jacob. He'll win for you. 844-24-JACOB. That's 844-24-JACOB. 844-24-JACOB. Or remember,
accident
Call Jacob.com and make sure you're following Call Jacob on Instagram. Go to @call.jacob for great advice and prizes and more. Mason in Ireland, Momo in for John 710.
The Black and Gold are back at home for a battle at BMO.
Absolutely electric to live and die in Los Angeles.
But it's not just any battle. It's a battle for Los Angeles.
It's the game in MLS. It's always the game in Major League Soccer when these two teams meet.
The fiercest rivalry in MLS. LAFC and Galaxy face off in downtown LA.
We expect nothing less than 90-plus minutes of amazing football.
Coverage begins Saturday at 4 p.m. on 710 ESPN and the ESPN LA app.
All right, Parker.
What's up, Greg?
All right, Parker.
Little Otani and Dodger blue. Yeah,
why are you looking at the camera?
I don't know. Let's start over. All right, Parker. Dodger spring training.
That's right, Greg. Otani and Dodger blue.
Yeah, Yamamoto's here. Pretty excited about that one.
Tons of new faces. I mean, Kike's back.
Yes, it's great. Maybe we should talk about it on the ESPN LA YouTube channel.
I like that idea. What do you say, 9:30, 9:55?
Right, leading right into Travis and Sliwa. Get a couple guests.
Maybe Marcus Grant. Travis Rogers, perhaps?
Yep. Just have a bunch of people come in. Maybe Clinton Yates will even find his way in.
Oh, you know, you always want to have the handsome man president right there.
Absolutely. All right, well, I think we should do that. We'll do it every day, Monday through Friday, 9:30 to 9:55 on the ESPN LA YouTube channel. Thanks to LAX.
The more aggressive he got last year, the better he started to hit. And it looks like he started it here.
It's an Ottawa cap. Mason in Ireland continues now.
What's up, people? It is going to be spring break.
I feel like spring break is, it was LAUSD was last week. Right now it's some other districts. And then my kid's school is not until the end of April. Like, it's just spring break all over the place.
Next week I'm going out to DHS. Nice. Going to do a lot of soaking out there.
DHS, is that what the locals call
DHS.
It?
DHS.
Desert Hot Springs.
DeAndre is from DHS.
Yeah?
He's not here yet.
Is that the 661 or is that a, what area code is that out there?
I don't know. It's Palm Springs ADJ.
Seven.
ADJ.
Why don't you say adjacent?
Because I wanted to say ADJ.
Because we're in. Because
I'm being hip.
Everything gets shortened down. Why do we have to shorten everything?
It's a little sus.
Yeah, it is sus.
See, like that.
Yeah.
It's, he, Yeah, he's a 760.
Is that 760? Okay.
The old 760.
760.
Yeah.
So, and then I'm speaking at Bowling Green State University.
I love this for you.
Yeah, I'm super excited about it. I've not been on campus in 37 years.
Do you still know people there? Do you know?
My four best friends from college are all coming to Bowling Green, and we're going to hang out next
Those are the ones you had the party at the beach house?
Party at the beach house. Yeah.
That was a reality show.
So it was. It was a crazy, crazy week. And we'll have a great night at Bowling Green. But I've not been there in a long time, and I've never been in a situation where I'm going to speak to a classroom of students about how to do this.
How many students are there?
I don't know. I'm speaking to two classes.
Okay.
A radio performance class.
Okay.
Which I don't think could be any more appropriate. Bergman was going to teach it till they heard the ZipRecruiter read.
That's right. After that, they said, you know what? You stay back in L.A.
And
that,
by the way,
we don't want you.
Stay tuned. There is a ZipRecruiter read with Greg Bergman coming up.
Can we get some hype music?
Purpose? Oh, yeah.
Like, should I just like mess up totally?
No.
I want you to know. I gave you some really good advice there.
Yeah.
You did give me very good advice.
What if I told you?
What?
Greg Bergman was going to
What if I told you?
This ZipRecruiter.
I've nailed this read before.
Yeah.
Yesterday was not that day.
Do you want to know my other thing when you're reading? You have to hear the words as you say them.
Oh my God. I don't hear the words. Sometimes I'm reading words and my mind is somewhere else.
That's the only way I can get myself to slow down.
Mace, we talked about it. You've said it to me. I'm going to say it here is that when we get feedback, we can either accept it or reject it.
No. I say we can either reject it or ignore it.
Right.
One or the other. If you get feedback as your friend, you can either reject it or ignore it.
Ignore
either
it.
Way.
Right. Sounds
you don't
right.
have to do anything
I believe
with
that's what they said in that big meeting,
no,
wasn't
that
it?
That was not what they said at all.
Reject or
well,
ignore.
I think
that's
he
what
chose
you
to ignore.
Hear.
Yeah.
That's what I hear.
Who doesn't like the feedback?
Hey,
that's not
you know what base your new answer needs to be?
Yeah.
I'm in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
So is Scott Kaplan.
Is Scott Kaplan in the Hall of Fame?
Yeah, the Pittsburgh Jewish Hall of Fame.
Yeah, Pittsburgh Jewish Hall of Fame. It's a big one.
I mean, I'm in the Southern California Jewish Sports Hall of Fame, too.
Are you?
Yeah.
Oh, congratulations.
I mean,
do you have a plaque or a trophy?
There's something
of
me up at the Skirball Center somewhere.
You know, the only
I emcee that event the next year.
The only thing I haven't won that I do secretly covet?
Yeah.
Host of the year?
Host
at the
of
Mandy's.
The year. Oh, yeah.
It's not secret. Mace.
Oh no, it is secret. Yeah. I've never said it before.
No,
hey, you just did.
Right. This is the first time. I've never campaigned. I've never tried. I've never pushed for it.
Are you going to campaign this year?
You know, as always, I will campaign for Mason and Ireland to be the show of the year.
Yeah,
just go full Mason
because I'm being super humble.
Yeah, go full Mason.
You know what
and go
I think
right
you need,
you.
And I don't want the embarrassment of losing.
That's it.
So
that's
I'm
the
not,
problem.
Not going to campaign and then have Sliwa win it.
I know.
He won last year.
I think he's going to go back to back.
That was one of my favorite moments. It was Momo reading off Alan Sliwa's name.
It was great.
Because
hold
I was
on.
So
Everybody,
genuinely.
Hold on. Just wait. Just wait. The host of the year. I can't believe this is happening. Oh, my God. I don't know what's going on here. I can't believe it's happening. Alan Sliwa.
That was great. That was great.
I sold that, huh?
You did. You sold it.
I think it was genuine because I was genuinely surprised, happy, really happy for him.
I was ecstatic when it happened.
Yeah.
It was so cool.
I mean, like, because I didn't have, and nobody tipped us.
Oh,
there was
no
tip. Like, there was no ballot box stuffing tipping or.
Ireland always says it's rigged. I don't believe it's rigged. I think it's completely legit.
We have no control of it. There's no way you can't even look at it. There's two people that know who wins anything. Tommy Lamb gets the results, and then the results go to
Carla.
Jorge. Jorge.
Oh, Jorge.
They go to Jorge, and that's it. Those two people are the only ones who know what the winner
is. I don't think that's true.
It is?
I believe it is true.
I don't know. The first year when I was going to be like a fill-in host.
Fill-in host
of
the year.
And Amanda Brown was still here. And I said something like, hey, you know, I'm really pushing hard for this award. Like, I don't want to embarrass myself if I don't win. She goes, you got nothing to worry about. Wink, wink.
Oh. So maybe
I was not told anything that year.
So you will not know.
I will. Not
I think she knew. I think she knew.
I'd like to know
she
a little bit in advance because I hate what I hate is that moment where
Susan
they announce
Lucci
someone
moment.
Else.
No one's gonna.
And
tell
then I've got to like all for. Oh, sweet! That's awesome, man. That's so great.
No, you should go the exact opposite way.
Way to go, Cappy! I'm so happy
like
for
you. Like you watched that Friends episode with Joey. when Joey like didn't win, he was yelling and like, "What is going on?" Oh yeah.
I always hate the I hate that at award show where they
show the losers.
The four losers.
Totally.
I'm like, and they all have to pretend like, "Oh, that's so great."
Yeah.
I had a spot on my mantle for that thing. So let's do a little Dodgers here.
Dodgers win.
Of course I do. Yeah. Dodgers win last night. They sweep the Giants. Shohei Ohtani hits his first home run as a Dodger. It was an exciting moment. I can't believe that we cannot find the Japanese call of Shohei Ohtani's home run.
So I tried. Brian tried. I reached out to people at Dodger fan sites. They tried. Nothing. I've gotten nothing.
If anybody has got access to that, tweet us. If you've seen the Japanese call or you have the... Because I would be interested in hearing that. The lady that got the ball, did she catch it? I didn't see.
She caught it.
She caught it?
Yeah, she caught it.
And then it ended up going back to Ohtani, right?
Yeah, so she caught it. They brought her down to Ohtani. I don't know if she actually met Ohtani. I don't think she did. But she got a bat. She got two hats and a ball. And I think they were all signed.
And he got a fistful of sunflower seeds in his face.
He did. I just hope that nothing hit his eye. That's all.
Yeah, no.
It's important. Don't hit his eye.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
That was all from Teoscar Hernandez.
And now this is 9 games in a row that they have officially scored 5 or more runs.
Yes.
And I heard somewhere that the record is 13. It's held by the 1932 Yankees, and that the Dodgers are chasing that. This is just what I heard.
Yeah, where'd you hear that? It sounds familiar.
Heard some Bobo talking about him on the radio.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
It's about that time, ladies and gentlemen.
Is that a Blue Review?
No, yeah. I did a Dodger report thing. It's like a minute long. And
oh, yeah. I hear those things.
Yeah, they're good.
Yeah, you
they're
hate
good.
Them. That's
all right. All right. So, and Blue Review's on every morning at 9:30.
9:30 to 9:55 with Parker Bell, who's right behind me, and then Marcus Grant 4 out of the 5 days.
Awesome. Nice.
Marcus did a good job yesterday.
Who did?
Marcus.
Oh, Marcus was great.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a really good time.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm getting all these Venmo requests. I'm not even on Venmo.
No, don't do those.
Do you know what they are? Listen, I have a Venmo request from Gore Matveyev, one from Nana Kruglova, one from Terence Alexeva, from Snejana Elieva.
Mace, I'm pretty sure that if you answer any of those requests, all of your funds will be gone.
Yes, I am not going to answer them. But it's amazing that they have that information, and apparently a lot of Russians want money from me. Right? Weren't those all Russian names?
Yeah.
Kruglova, Matveyev.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Russians.
You know, it
me.
Was. I get requests sometimes on Venmo.
Yeah,
that's one of the things that's not good on Venmo. It's like any random person that's not your friend or has any connection to you can like request money from you.
See, it's easy for me because I'm not even on Venmo. I have no idea why these people are requesting this for me. I'm not. If they requested Apple Pay, they'd be all set.
You send it right away.
Zelle goes right there.
Sure.
All right, so coming up next, you're going to spin the wheel of questions. In the meantime, it is the much-hyped return of Greg Bergman reading the ZipRecruiter spot.
Putting so much pressure.
Super,
you can do it, Greg.
Super
Thanks,
excited
Momo.
About
hear the
this.
Hear the words as you say them.
Do we have some do we have like some dramatic music of some kind?
Wait a second. Okay, do I go now?
Yes.
Okay.
Take it away.
Did you know, Momo, did you know that it can take now up to 11 weeks on average to hire for an open position? That's almost 2.5 months. So if you're hiring for a growing business, do you really have that kind of time to wait? Well, if you're listening today, I've got some advice for you. Stop waiting and start using ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter can help you find qualified candidates for all your roles fast. And right now, you can try it for free at ZipRecruiter.com/LA. ZipRecruiter uses powerful matching technology to quickly find and send you the most qualified people for your roles. You can check out the people that ZipRecruiter sends you, and if you really like one or two, you can personally invite them to apply with one click, which may make them apply even sooner. Plus, here's how quickly ZipRecruiter can work to help you hire. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. So speed up your hiring process with ZipRecruiter. See why 3.8 million businesses have come to ZipRecruiter for their hiring needs. Just go to this exclusive web address to try ZipRecruiter for free. ZipRecruiter.com/LA. Too soon. Again, that's ZipRecruiter.com/LA. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire.
Yay! I made up for it. Hey. You're a grown-up broadcaster. All right, spin the wheel of questions next. Momo's in for Ireland, 710 ESPN.
wheel of questions. Producer Brian Cohen, are you ready with that wheel? Hit it, Jack.
All right, spinning the wheel of questions. Oh, it's interesting. Brian, do you have the Backstreet Boys song?
Oh.
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay. So the question is about Backstreet Boys.
Oh, I might like this one.
So AJ McLean, who's one of the Backstreet Boys, has said that he and the other members of the band, Nick Carter, Howie Duroux, Brian Littrell, and Kevin Richardson, they've gone to therapy.
Okay.
So
together, like group therapy?
Together, group therapy to hold the band together.
Okay.
And I always wondered, like, Ireland and I have never needed it, but I'm curious from everybody if you've been involved or how you've been involved in therapy. There's the Backstreet Boys.
Okay, well, I mean, it's hard for me to have a serious conversation with this song is on. My fire, my one desire.
Come on, Brian.
Leave when I say
I want it that way.
It's so good.
It is such a great song. All right, so they went to therapy, Mama. Have you been in therapy?
Yeah, all the time.
Like personal therapy, couples? Have you ever done couples therapy?
No, we haven't done couples therapy.
You and Nev haven't had to go you know, sit on the couch?
Yeah,
and...
no. We do separate, like I've gone to a therapist for 20 years probably.
Yeah, yeah.
But different ones.
You just different every time?
Yeah, no. Now I have one that I've stuck with. I really like her. She's great. The one, I don't know, maybe in my mid-20s, late 20s, something like that. I went to her for a while. She was good, but I think she retired and moved on, whatever.
Right.
And then the thing about therapy is that when you go, you are holding yourself accountable too. Like
sure.
You're setting forth intentions, somebody's giving you feedback, and then you are working on them because you're going to see them again next
right.
week.
Right.
So, like, if you didn't do the things you said you were going to do, there's this accountability.
They hold you accountable, exactly.
So, yeah, I think it's great. Once I went for the first couple of times, I was like, oh, everyone should do this. This is to me, just as important as going to the gym and getting 20 minutes
right.
on an elliptical.
Sure, sure. Bergman therapy.
Yeah, absolutely. I've gone to therapy for myself. I've gone to therapy, couples therapy.
Did you do couples therapy? How's that work?
Well, the first time...
I guess it didn't.
I mean, there's been a few with the ex-wife.
Yeah.
The first time it worked, and actually that's why we ended up getting married in the first place.
Okay.
Oh.
And then it didn't work after that, and we're divorced. So,
right, so
that did not work.
So therapy works before marriage.
Therapy
before marriage.
That actually worked.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying that's a little bit of a...
That's a red flag.
Yeah.
If while you're dating, you have to go to therapy...
Yeah, it's a little...
Yeah.
Probably shouldn't go through with it. Brian, what about you? Therapy?
Never have, honestly.
Never have?
Yeah, never have. I have nothing against it or anything, just never got the opportunity or found the right lane to kind of take it or whatnot, but yeah, I don't know.
Okay. Well, I brought it up also... First of all, I think it's interesting. Backstreet Boys, you can imagine those five guys going into therapy.
I'm not as big on group therapy, to be honest.
Well,
I find it a little...
What do you mean by group therapy?
Like, they're going to... All the Backstreet Boys are sitting in a room together?
Because they say, AJ McLean says, this is like our first marriage. So they're trying... It's like couples therapy, marriage therapy for the entire group so they can get along. But I wanted to talk about therapy a little bit because, you know, I work with the LA County Department of Mental Health. And right now or whenever, they've got a 24/7 helpline that's available to you at 800-854-7771. That's for service referrals if you're looking for a therapist, crisis counseling if you're in crisis, and just if you need somebody to talk to, 800-854-7771. You can also visit their website at dmh.lacounty.gov, the LA County Department of Mental Health. It's hope, it's recovery, and it's well-being. All right, so
we have the Japanese call.
Oh, we found the Japanese call of Shohei Ohtani's home run.
Yes, somebody DM'd it to me. So thank you very much.
Have been on this all morning.
Yeah, we could not find it.
It was from the
a Django. Listener found it within 20 seconds.
Yeah.
Trey Bridges 23. Thank you.
Thank you, Trey Bridges 23.
You had it.
You have it, Brian.
3-1 やりました。しかしこの後にはフリーマンが控えています。 来たか！来た！来たか！来た！来たか！行った！ついに出ました！誰もが待ち望んでいた瞬間！
ドジャーブルーのユニフォームで大谷第1号。
Music here.
噛み締めるようにホームイン。
Hi, there it is.
That was great.
Courtesy NHK, which I think is the like the Japanese big television.
Is that like
network.
ESPN or something?
That was great. Yeah.
I think it's actually like regular TV in Japan.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It's like ABC.
Exactly. It's one of those. So, yeah, that's very cool. Last night was really cool. And I think now, you know, maybe Shohei goes on a tear because the one thing I'll say is he was hitting the ball hard.
Yeah.
And he wasn't finding spots. Last night, obviously, went yard. I think he's going to break out now. I think he's going to go on a run.
Yeah, because everybody else was. Like, Mookie's hitting the cover off the ball. Freddie, Hernandez. Like, everybody has been hitting so well right now and driving the ball to the yard. And he's the one guy who hadn't homered.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think, I'm not saying he was pressing, but I think each game that went by, especially when he popped out to end that one,
yeah,
the
right.
one game with the
right.
bases loaded and all that, I think he was pressing a little bit, and it probably feels pretty good to get that first one
off. You know what I didn't think about him? Just the way he carries himself, the expressions. He's just a super likable guy.
Yeah.
He's really, like, immediately likable. He's got a really open face, really great smile.
Yeah.
It's exciting. I mean, honestly, like, in my house, I can be drifting away from the game, but when Ohtani steps to the plate, it's like, I am locked in. I am right there.
Ohtani's up.
Ohtani's up. Everybody free. Dogs quiet. It's Shohei.
He's got this Babe Ruth kind of presence to him, too, when he gets in the box. Mm-hmm. Like, he's not moving around a lot. He's just kind of
He's got a very
there.
Still stance, you're right.
Do you feel that way about the first three batters? As soon as Mookie gets to the plate, I stop everything. Because then
yeah.
I know those first three batters, I'm like, I'm locked in.
Yeah, I am too. But don't
Shohei is a
don't you see
one?
A differentiation between...
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
I think there's a difference between Shohei and the other two. Because Freddie and Mookie failed in the playoffs 2 years in a row. Right, like the Freddie and Mookie were trending
Correct.
On Twitter for like not hitting in the playoffs, and
one for
like,
24 or
yeah,
whatever.
Whatever
I
that
agree.
Was. I mean, who's counting? You know,
I agree.
Was it 23? One what? For 23? Something like that.
One for 22, I think. One
so
for
they
22.
They sort of lost the aura of. I don't want to say it's not invincibility. It's this like supernatural quality. That,
yeah, I mean, let's
oh,
be
Shohei
honest.
Has.
They went 1-6 in the playoffs yeah. over the last two seasons.
It's held against them.
Yeah, no, it absolutely is. But Mookie's
it's
on
humanized
such a tear.
Them too.
Yeah, yeah, but Mookie's on such a tear right
oh,
now.
Oh yeah, he's but he's
like
just a hot hitter right now.
Yeah.
Like he's
yeah.
a really he's really good, and he's on a tear. He came out of the gates hot. So is Freddie.
I don't
see
know.
Oscar Hernandez, same thing.
See Oscar Hernandez,
yeah, but, yeah.
what a player!
But like Shohei has this presence about him when he steps in the box.
Yep.
It's like here's Babe Ruth stepping into the box.
There is some yeah, there is something about that when he steps to the plate.
I know at spring training when I went, everybody was like, "When is Shohei up?"
Yeah.
Like you would time. I was in line once, and those lines are kind of long in spring training, and I got out of line to go watch him. Because I heard Shohei's up. Okay. I can get that hot dog later.
I get some really good Shohei stuff coming up next that I dug up.
Yeah.
I want to get to that. And also, I said the six signs that you're eating at a bad restaurant. We got that coming up for you. Are we going to do 2 o'clock call today?
We don't have to.
Yeah, let's skip it today.
Okay.
Do it.
No, why'd you get my hopes up?
Just don't.
Hey,
good.
Everyone, this is a call for all of you. If you want 2 o'clock call of the day to continue, don't suck.
Yeah. Yeah, do okay. not. Give us something good. Take on the
Bring it.
Take on the Lakers, take on Shohei, on LeBron. Anything that we've talked about today.
I mean, we can
today.
Talk about the weather. Like, if you want to call in and talk
sure,
about
the weather is
why
good.
Is it
yeah.
always, why can't it just be spring?
Right, there's a cold front going through right now.
I'm upset with this. It's like, it gave us a taste of spring. It was warm and sunny, and
Yesterday
now it's cold again.
It was absolutely beautiful. That
Glorious.
Was a beautiful day.
Glorious
beautiful
spring day. And then it's like, nope. Right
we went down
to
the beach. It was fantastic.
Yeah, and then this morning it's like 35 degrees again.
Yeah.
I'm like, whatever.
Yeah.
It's not 35.
So if you want to talk
like
about
it.
That. God knows why. 877-710-ESPN. 877-710-ESPN. Certainly Momo does. Mason in Ireland. Momo in for John. 710-ESPN.
G's of LA Sports Radio. We're here each weekday, 1 to 4 p.m. for your afternoon. Sandwiched between Travis and Sliwa and Sonato and Cap. Mason and Ireland continues now.
Very underrated group.
Very underrated.
I mean, I know they sold a lot of records.
I think
they're, people
aren't
make
they
fun
touring
of it now.
Again?
I feel like they were out at Yamava.
I think like New Kids on the Block is touring with 98 Degrees or something like that. One of those. Ireland knows every member of
apparently,
every boy band for some reason.
All the stuff that we thought was cool when we were in high school, and I'm including you in this we, even though probably different eras.
You and I about the same. About the same.
Giving you that.
Yeah.
Apparently, all that music and all the fashion are coming back. So, like, they're listening to Sublime. Like, the high school kids now, they're into, like, the 90s music.
Yeah.
Sublime is the best.
They're listening. Sublime's they awesome. Got, like, baggy jeans on and flannel tops. Like, remember when everyone wore flannel tops?
Yes.
It was, like, the Kurt Cobain era, the
now,
grunge
Bergman
band.
Now, Bergman hates grunge.
I'm not a grunge fan. Never have.
I'm a big grunge guy.
You went a little to the cake and...
No, I didn't like
I do
Cake.
Like Cake. They're a good band.
They're
Cake's
okay.
version of...
We're going the distance.
No, but Cake's version of I Will Survive is the best version of I Will Survive.
Pretty good. I went more towards Sublime.
Oh, okay.
Like 311.
Oh, yeah, okay.
That kind of music.
That area.
Yeah.
Well, Metallica is, to me, the bellwether.
Yeah.
Are you in on Metallica, or is it too...
No, it was fine.
That's not grunge, though.
That's not grunge at all.
Right. That's the bellwether. Like, are you more Metallica, or are you more Nirvana?
Yeah, no, I did not like Nirvana or Bush or any of those.
I ones. Love Nirvana. Really,
but all that stuff is back now.
Pearl it's Jam? All,
by the way.
Pearl Jam, yeah.
My daughter is 12 years old, Riley.
Yeah.
She wears such big, baggy pants.
Yeah.
I love it. More clothes.
Yeah.
Put all the clothes on.
All right, let's get a 2 o'clock
you know
call
saying?
Of the day in here. Let's go to Cecilia in Whittier. Cecilia, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How
are
you?
Great, Cecilia. What's up?
Okay, listen. I was floored today to find out, do any of you know where the Boysenberry came from?
You know, it's funny. This is one of those burning questions that I don't know the answer to. Where did the Boysenberry come from?
Is a Boysenberry a cross between a blackberry and a blueberry?
No, you would think so. Okay, get this. So this man back in the 20s that grew up in Anaheim, California, his last name was Boysen. Okay?
Ah.
Name Rudolph Boysen. And he developed, he was a horticulturist.
Yeah.
And decided to just name this berry after him. I thought that was awesome.
I don't hate that.
That's amazing.
He named the berry after himself.
Yeah, named the berry. And we are the proud owners of the Boysenberry. Anaheim, California.
Anaheim, California, home of the Boysenberry. Oh, they also got
that's
Disneyland.
Right.
But it's the Boysenberry.
That's a good call right there.
That's great, Cecilia.
That's
this
the
is,
content we're looking
to me,
for. Thank you.
That's very interesting. Let's do,
I'm into that.
Let's do one more. Let's go to David and Hawthorne. David, you're on 710. Good afternoon.
Hey, Mason, Ramona, you guys are awesome. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I actually had the pleasure to meet you guys at a Yasiel Puig poker tournament years ago.
That was a great night. I made the final table that night.
That's awesome. I didn't even know that.
I was out.
So cool.
I was out fast.
Yeah, no. That's so cool. Yeah, we took a couple pictures, and I got you guys up in my man cave, which I call the Forum Club.
Nice, man. Nice.
So, wanted to talk to you guys about the Laker playoff run. I'm a diehard Laker fan, bleed purple and gold, and you know, love the way they've been playing just of late. I want to say they went 5-1 on the road.
Yep.
That was impressive. Maybe 9-1 after the last 10. The starting five has got some major chemistry, which shows the bench here and there, not a little bit inconsistent.
Yep.
But this is the main flag. This is the main concern that I have. AD and LeBron James have maybe lost, or excuse me, have been on the court and have been present, healthy, and have not missed more than 10 games this season.
Yeah.
And we are still in the playoff play-in game. We are still in 9th seed.
Oh, I see what
so
you're
does
saying.
That really mean, yeah, does that really mean we can, like, potentially beat the Denver Nuggets?
No. A lot of this is, like, completely matchup dependent. Like, the Lakers are playing really well. Mm-hmm. Bergman pointed out since February 1st, they're 20-8.
It's good.
Pretty good. They've won 8 of 9.
Yeah.
8 of 9 Yes.
8 of 9 So they're on a roll. They're playing really good, really well. But everybody in the Western Conference is playing really well. And there are two terrible matchups for the Lakers.
Mm-hmm.
One is Sacramento.
Yeah.
They're 0-4 against Sacramento. And Domantas Sabonis has beaten Anthony Davis every time they faced each other. So you want to avoid Sacramento. And Denver is lights out. If you get, if you're the 8 and Denver's the 1, forget it. It's over. They can't beat Denver.
And I see his point, which is, you know, the knock on the Lakers before was, okay, if AD and LeBron are healthy, then they can beat anyone. But they have relatively been healthy, and they are still 9th.
Yes. And I think that's where they're going to wind up.
I do, too.
I mean, it just the way they're playing really well, I think they go into a tough stretch in the schedule. They actually finished tough.
Mm-hmm.
That was a what we would call an easy road trip. But if you look at the games they've got left now, you know, they've got Cleveland, they've got Minnesota, they've got Golden State, they've got who else? Cleveland, Minnesota, Golden State, New Orleans.
And they have Memphis also.
And and New Orleans. And Memphis. So Memphis is the gimme out of that. 5 games left. So 4 of the games are against above 500 teams.
Right.
So they got to finish strong and hope the teams in front of them lose. There's still just a game and a half between them and the 7. So they still have a chance to avoid having to play 2 games.
I don't like that 9-10 game. That worries me because it'd be against the Warriors, who are really hot.
Really
right
hot,
now.
Yeah.
And they're kind of figuring it out. I think the Warriors, the Lakers should beat them.
Yep.
But I don't Steph Curry in any game.
Yeah, in one they had a one-gamer against Golden State a couple of years ago.
Close.
It was across the street. It was
LeBron hit the game winner.
Yeah, it was a great game. It was a great game. But you're right. I mean, the first matchup, there could be no playoff run. It is possible that there is no playoff run. What do you think there will be one?
I do, but I don't like that 9-10 game. I just like if for either of those teams. Those two teams are two teams I think could actually win a series if they get into the playoffs.
Right.
But they're going to, one of them is going to be out after the first game if they're 9-10.
And it all depends on what happens at the one, because Oklahoma City's up there, Denver's up there, Minnesota's up there. If Denver's the one, you don't want to be the 8.
Yeah. And the only way you can not be the 8 is if you finish 7th or
if
8th.
OKC is the 1.
Yeah.
I think you do want to be the 8.
But I don't think they'll be the 1. I think it looks I think it'll be Minnesota or Denver as the 1, and OKC slides to the 3 spot. That's what it feels like right now. OKC just lost 2 in a row.
Right.
They lost to New York and then Philly. Or no, Boston. Sorry, Philly and then Boston.
Right.
They fell off a little bit there.
Because Minnesota and Denver tied Oklahoma City's game back.
Right.
So if it were...
Minnesota and Denver play again next week. So that'll settle that.
Yeah, yeah. They have identical 53-23 records. Yeah, I mean, you would think the Lakers are 11 games over 500. If you would have told me that at the beginning of the year, I would have said absolutely.
It's pretty good.
And they're going to be at least the 6.
What did you say a little while ago? They had to get to 48 wins.
Yeah, I had a bet that they have to get to
46
wins.
You're going to win that.
Yeah,
what
I'm
going to
win that bet.
What are they at right now?
They 44. Have 44 wins.
Yeah, they'll get to 46.
Yeah, so 46.
And they'll still be the 9.
And if you would have told me that at the beginning of the season, hey, they're going to wind up with 46 wins, I would say, that's pretty good.
You know, what did they have last year?
It's a good question.
I have to look it up. But you also had a bet on the Lakers in the 6th seed.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen, but it's still possible. It's
still possible.
They're 2 back of Dallas, who's the 5.
So, right.
So they have it's possible, but they need to win every single game.
Last year they were 4 games over 500. This year they're 11 games over 500 so far.
You know what I have to do? I have to ask Daniel who is going to get the 5 or the 6 seed, because he's really good at picking NBA
games. Oh, is he really?
Really good. Like, I just asked him last year. He, like, nailed it. He called the Miami Heat winning. He was 4
really?
At the time.
Wow.
So I will go, when I get home today, I will ask and I will send you that.
Was it like one rattle says Lakers, rattle says.
No,
and
pretty
then
much Daniel always just
rattle
says,
he shakes is the one.
Every game that we watch, whether it's a Dodger game or a Laker game, Daniel just says, which one's LeBron?
Oh, is that right?
Yeah,
even if it's
LeBron
a Dodger
is,
game.
Yeah, even if it's a Dodgers.
Now, hold a man, is he?
5.
5.
5.5.
5.5.
5.5.
All grown up.
Even if it's a Dodger game, he says, where's LeBron?
Yeah, yeah.
We were watching, but he'll know. He's really good at picking those games.
So, Momo, Monday or Tuesday night, we had our fantasy baseball draft.
Yeah. And you were so quiet.
I was quiet.
I was like, where's Mace? Did he fall asleep?
Yeah, no,
like,
I was drafting.
You know what? Mace is the guy who every time somebody has a player that you kind of want, he'll always throw that extra dollar or two to make to squeeze an
just
extra
to
dollar.
Just squeeze a little money out of
squeeze
the table.
A extra.
Yeah, exactly.
And then you'll put up somebody who's got some steals. I'll be like, last steals in the
last
draft.
Last steals in the draft. Now, were you happy with your fantasy baseball draft?
Okay. Yeah, I thought I did okay.
Yeah, you did not have Uncle Phil, and you still did fine.
No, it was fine. I'm fine without Phil.
You finished, let's see, right now you're running...
First.
No. Yeah, you're running first right
yeah,
now.
I drafted a good team. Now, I didn't think positionally enough. So I ended up with a bunch of weird outfielders at the end for like $1.
Who's your most fun player?
Oh, I got Freddie.
Oh, that's right. You got Freddie.
I was like, I was determined. I was either going to get Mookie or Freddie.
See, the only Dodger I got was Max Muncy.
That's good. That's a good one.
I mean, I like it a lot, but yeah. I knew I could squeeze $51
yeah,
out
did.
Of Shohei and $51 out of...
I got Freddie for 48.
48,
yeah,
exactly.
I was happy. Freddie for under 50, okay.
Isn't it weird that we had somebody drafting, the computer was drafting for
I don't think it was really him.
You don't
I think
what?
The commissioner was drafting for Mike Robin.
No, he was not.
I think he was.
No way. That was AI. AI drafted that team.
I don't think so. Put him on a lie detector.
You don't think the computer auto-drafted
no.
that? You think somebody else was actually drafting?
Yeah.
Who was it?
Mike Rosenfeld.
No!
He was the commissioner. He runs the thing.
Yeah,
I think he realized the AI wasn't working or the auto-draft wasn't working, and he had to jump in there and bid a little bit.
It is weird. Now, once
he never bid on anyone when Mike was bidding, when Birds was bidding.
The openings, well, nobody bid against the computer. As soon
right,
as we
once
saw
he
the
started,
computer go,
we were like, okay.
No, he's going
to
get
that guy. Well, I just said I'm going to let him have a player because I didn't want him to have no players.
Right.
He ended up with like $43 extra.
Momo, I got a special surprise for you coming up. At our friend Alex Michelson from Channel 11.
Oh, boy.
Wants to come on and talk to you about doing the weather on Channel 11.
I want to make this happen. I just want to do it over the summer when I'm like not in the middle
of
the
season. Yeah, when you're not in the middle of everything.
And also I want to lose like another 5 or 10 pounds so I can look like all cool.
Sleek?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because when you do the weather, it's like full body. I want to wear like a good outfit, not just like top behind, you know, good top and jacket. Like
yeah,
you got to
right.
be like suited and
sure,
booted.
Sure, sure. Suited and booted.
I want to nail that.
Yeah. All right. Coming up next, the 6 signs that you're at a bad restaurant.
Is one of them the letter grade? It's one of them the letter grade.
Well, that's an obvious one.
It's
yeah.
a curved.
If you see a B, forget it.
I don't know. I'd eat at a B.
I will not eat. I will only eat at A's. Does anybody eat at B's? If you see a B,
I have eaten at a few B's.
Have you?
Yeah.
It tastes a little
isn't
better.
That risky?
Like taco shops. I mean, you gamble every day, so you know.
That's a great answer. You can get a B for a lot of things that has nothing to do with the food.
Yeah, but still, do you eat
no,
at a
no,
B?
I'm usually at an A only.
I gotta
but
be
also, I'll be honest with you, I don't actually pay attention.
Okay, yes, if you ever want to go down a rabbit hole, this is a Travis and Sliwa bit. Hmm. If you want to go down a rabbit hole, go where they find, where they list which restaurants have certain grades and why. So they'll list why the restaurant got the C, or they'll
right.
list why the restaurant got the B. And it's kind of fun to read. They're like, oh, they found a, you know, rat remains or
yeah,
something or
yeah,
whatever. Or they didn't oh the meat was not at the right temperature all the time.
Gross.
Like but it's good to read it. It's kinda like
although
okay.
when I owned the movie theaters over at USC yeah. at University Village, we got a B 1 year because we didn't have a sink. Like what does a sink have to do with popcorn?
Yeah. Well, the thing on Curb, there, that was you saw that one.
Yeah, I saw that one. Because switching the
one of the waiters
around.
Like to do something on the floor.
Exactly, exactly. All right, coming up next for you, more with Momo and the restaurants and the Dodgers and the Lakers. All that stuff is coming up. In the meantime, hey, for more than 40 years right here in L.A., when it comes to the best TV, sound systems, outdoor theater, home automation, customer service, only one choice. It is Mir Audio Video in Westwood. Mir.
I'm really impressed.
Up there. That's what I meant to hit. At Mir, they've got the top tech guys in the world, which means when your system is installed, it works exactly as it's designed the first time and every time. This is why ESPN LA, all these TVs in here, we trust Mir. Why me, Ireland, Momo, we all trust Mir. She's a Mir client. Anybody who takes home... takes their home or office electronics seriously, it's got to be Mir. Any questions, call Isaac or Roy. One of them will pick up the phone. Tell him Mason in Ireland. And Momo sent you. He'll hook you up for sure. It's 310-234-4010. That's 310-234-4010. 310-234-4010. Or check them out at MirrorAudioVideo.com. Mason in Ireland, Momo in for John, 710.
The black and gold are back at home for a battle at BMO.
Absolutely electric to live and die in Los Angeles.
But it's not just any battle. It's a battle for Los Angeles.
It's the game in MLS. It's always the game in Major League Soccer when these two teams meet.
The fiercest rivalry in MLS. LAFC and Galaxy face off in downtown LA.
We expect nothing less than 90-plus minutes of amazing football.
Coverage begins Saturday at 4 p.m. on 710 ESPN and the ESPN LA app.
Big news, Laker fans. John Ireland here. You can now stream every Lakers game on the ESPN LA app. Don't miss a second of the action with Michael Thompson and I on the call. Plus, all your live and local Lakers talk every day in the palm of your hand.
You're one tap away from everything Lakers.
You could even win Lakers tickets.
Download the ESPN LA app and bam!
Download the ESPN LA app at the App Store and Google Play.
Seven Teddy ESPN. Don't get it twisted, yo. The most downloaded sports radio show in Los Angeles. The podcast, that is.
Based in Ireland, the number one most downloaded sports podcast in Los Angeles. The number one most downloaded sports podcast in Los Angeles. And we thank all of our podcast listeners for that.
If you ever miss a moment, get your fill anytime. Just search Mason in Ireland wherever you get your podcast.
All right, Momo's here today. Momo, you know what we need?
What?
Brian, you know what we need?
What?
Bergman?
What?
Fuck was...
Come on, guys!
Oh, my God. Every time you get me with that every time.
Whoopie-doo.
Oh, this is the cake version of I Will Survive.
It is, yes.
It's a good one, yeah. I like it.
Yeah.
Next best thing to, what is it, Gloria Gaynor, I think is the one that sang.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. So, okay, Larry David, one of the funniest people in the world.
Yeah.
Of course, we all love Curb Your Enthusiasm.
You got me into it. I'm like jumping on the bandwagon for the final season.
How great is Leon?
He's so good.
Oh, my God. He is so
funny. Oh, he was
funny.
So funny. And the zipper bit.
The zipper bit's great. I love the bit where he talks about coming up with a car that runs on pee. And he called it a Pius. He's just priceless.
So good.
Priceless. All right, so
He's
Larry David.
He's very right on this, by the way.
On which?
You're about to play.
Okay, yeah, that's right. So Larry David was on with Rich Eisen this week.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And Larry's on a quest. I want to see if you think he can succeed. Here he is.
This, what is it called, the UFL?
Yes, sir.
That's starting up.
Yes.
And you know my, you know how I feel about the goalposts. So I, my agent,
yes,
got me on the phone with Dwayne Johnson.
Who's he? So you went straight up the flagpole.
I went straight up to, and he called me, and we had a conversation.
Did he know what you were asking for?
No, he didn't know. I thought it was going to happen. He was completely into it.
So, again, your idea is to remove the goalposts entirely
yes,
from the football.
Yes, remove goalposts.
Okay.
Yeah, that was the idea.
And so you pitched him, like, how did that sound? I mean,
What I said to you on the show, there's no reason for him. Yeah. Suppose there was a baseball game and there were two parallel bars in deep center field that were 12 feet apart, and you could get a guy off the bench to hit a fungo, and if he got through the bars, you'd get a run. I mean, what's the point? It has nothing to do with the game. I gotta tell you, if there's one thing I could accomplish in my life, if I could get rid of these goalposts, I will die a happy man.
There you have it.
That will give me more pleasure than anything.
Oh, that's great.
Now, Bergman actually 100% agrees with Larry David.
100%.
That's right. What's the point?
Oh, Momo.
Field goals.
Thank you so much.
You would just get rid of field goals altogether.
Yeah, there's no point to them.
Oh, look at you.
There's drama involved in field
goals.
I know,
but like, it's like this football is a game with big, strong dudes crashing into each other and tackling, and it has nothing to do with kicking a ball.
Right, but it all comes down to the drama of lining up the kick.
Yeah,
is
so
the
little guy with the good, who used to play soccer, decides the most important game.
Some random dude that has never touched the field for the
could
entire
not tackle
game,
anybody.
Four quarters, never steps out onto the field, possibly.
It's a skill. It's a skill. You gotta learn how to do it.
Comes out,
yeah,
and it's like, okay,
deals with the pressure.
I have to kick a 65-yard
pressure of the world on his shoulders.
Yeah, but he has nothing to do with the game.
Right. I would argue with you this. If, let's say, Patrick Mahomes is down, Kansas City's trailing, okay?
Right.
He's at his own 20-yard line. Yeah. He only needs to get to the other guy's 30 in order to kick a field goal and tie. You want to eliminate the field goal that could keep Patrick Mahomes from tying that game?
Yeah.
Get in the end zone.
Get in the end zone.
But
get in the end zone.
But
the
it's
other
much harder to go 80
it would
yards.
Actually,
oh, no, it's
to go.
Harder.
No, so the field goal is basically a reward for not being able to score.
Correct. Yes.
That's exactly what it is.
It is.
It's a reward for not being able to score
right,
a touchdown.
And I want Patrick Mahomes to have that reward so
and,
that we
the
get
truth,
to see
but
him
the
play
opposite,
another
but
series.
Now play it out, though. If there were no field goals and you have three plays and you can't move the ball and you're on your own 20, now there's a real punishment for not being able to move the ball because you're going to give the ball back to the other team in really good field position.
I've never been in more in sync with you.
Right.
Momo.
We don't have to get rid of the punter.
Punter stays.
You guys go
punter
ahead and do
can
the
stay.
Show. You guys
punter
go
stays
and do the show.
Because you don't have to go. Like four.
There's really no. There's
four
like,
downs.
Wait
fine.
A minute. Why not? Right. If you're doing
no.
it, why not get rid of
if
the punter?
You
got to go
for
it.
No, because if you get the ball on your own 20-yard line,
you got
to
score.
And you don't get to the and you don't get 10 yards.
No kickers.
You can punt it away.
We
can
just say that the quarterback throws it instead of punt it.
Correct. No,
that would
no,
be
no,
more
no.
in line
no,
with
no.
the actual
we
game.
Can keep the punter.
No.
It could be a deliberate throw punt.
No. If you're going to get rid of the field, you got to get rid of all
no,
kickers.
You
got to go for
okay.
it on every
so let's get rid
down,
of all the kickers.
Let's see what happens. Yeah.
So Patrick Mahomes.
All bets
it's,
off.
Okay,
no kickers.
They get the ball at the 20. They go six yards, and now it's fourth down and four. So
you
instead of punting, he either goes for it or he throws the ball as far as he can down the field,
no,
and
no,
that's
no.
the
he's go
punt.
It's a punt. It's a throw punt.
I'm okay with the punt.
That's far more in sync with what's actually happening in a football game 100%. Than any of the kicking things.
It's very true. Your only reason that you don't like it because that's how it's always been done. But you can change things.
No, I'm looking at it from a perspective of it adds drama to the game.
That's not adding drama.
Because it does add drama. It comes down to the last second, and you're trying to kick a field goal?
25-yard field goals and ruin games. Idiot kickers like Mike Vanderjet.
Look how worked up you are over kickers.
Yeah,
this is the drama.
I'm sorry, Cappy. Cappy's going to hear me say this.
Oh, he's going to hate
kickers
it.
Are not football players.
No, they're not. I don't dispute that.
So why should a non-football player have that much effect over the game?
For the drama.
Oh, jeez.
It's dramatic when somebody lines up for a field goal with a chance to tie or win.
They'll just try to score more. They'll just be a lot more like plays on fourth down.
You know what else is dramatic?
What?
Patrick Mahomes running around in the backfield on fourth down trying to get into the end zone.
Yeah.
Touchdown.
When you play flag football, you don't have kickers.
What if it's picked off? I mean, oh, my God, the drama.
Flag football, you just throw it like on fourth down. You go, okay. It's a good call.
That's how it's always been. You have to keep it because it's always been.
You know what? Is this the anti-fold?
He should fold on this.
You should fold.
I'm not folding.
You're just playing the sideball music over and over.
Yeah, look at me not folding.
Look at you not folding.
They all say I'm out folding.
You know what? Ireland was going to fold.
If it was Ireland, 100%, you would have folded. Would have folded if that was Ireland.
I will never fold with Ireland. Never fold with
Never again.
Except on the Lakers. The Lakers, I have to fold.
No, don't fold.
Yeah, because sometimes I got to throw
play
my
the Seinfeld music.
Sometimes I got to throw myself on the grenade for Ireland.
Yeah, I know.
Because he gets blamed for stuff I say.
This is what you do when you don't want to fold, and you just are like, okay, I'm done with this.
Correct. Well, it's also, it's a way to change the subject.
But that's like your way of saying we're done.
Well, yeah,
we're done here. Wrap it up.
Don't you think we're kind of done? We're at loggerheads. We disagree. Let's move on.
And you're not going to fold.
I will not fold. No.
Okay.
We should call Ireland just to see.
I know.
He's in the air.
He's in the air. Yeah, Ireland's in the air.
Text him.
I want to know
Wi-Fi.
If we're having Alex Michelson at 3 o'clock, I want to know what he thinks. He's a football fan.
Oh, he's a big football fan. Yeah, we'll definitely find out.
You didn't think that was going to get that big a reaction, did you?
I didn't.
I'm fired up.
He thought you were going to go on his side.
I know.
No, I
usually do.
It's better that she does. You know what I like? I like being alone on an island.
There you are.
Alone on an island.
Especially when the show's over.
Do you agree? Do you agree, by the way, Brian, that they should get rid of the kickers?
50-50, but I'm on the – if you get rid of the kickers, punters got to go too.
Yeah, I agree.
It's one and one or the other.
You can't be 50-50. You have to be –
Well, that's what I'm saying. If you keep the kickers and the punters got to stay too, but if you get rid of the kickers, punters got to go.
Get rid of all the kickers.
All or nothing.
Sorry, Cappy.
Yeah.
All right, so –
Cappy's driving around from South L.A. just fired up.
I think he's out – isn't he skiing?
Yeah.
I think Cappy's like a Big Bear or something.
No, he's in Mammoth.
So I've been teasing this for a while, so
yeah,
I should probably
know.
Get to it. The signs that you're at a bad restaurant. What pops up for you if you're in a restaurant?
Takes too long for the waiter to come over and bring me some water.
Okay. You say do it next?
Do it next.
Okay, we'll do it next. And then we got What's Up, Fool.
Yeah.
And then we got Alex Michelson teaching you weather.
Oh, I'm excited.
That's coming up.
Wait, he doesn't do the weather, though.
No, but he's going to
facilitate
you.
Okay.
Because he's a...
Very excited about
this. Yeah, it's
been
really
some
good.
Wild weather lately.
Has been. Big cold front moving
Big
through right
Big cold front.
Stationary front, I think. Big ridge of high pressure. I'm
ridge
just using weather
it's
terms.
It's great. It's so good.
All right. Mason in Ireland, 710 ESPN.
continues now.
Okay, we're all supposed to say this because he's listening right now. Hi, Danny.
Hi, Daniel.
Hi, Daniel.
Mommy. He's driving home. Apparently, he was telling everyone in the preschool parking lot.
That mom's on the radio?
Yeah, mom's on the radio.
Oh, she's so cool. She's one of the cool moms.
You know what? This is big for me because for most of the time, he has no idea what I do for a living. He doesn't care. He doesn't matter.
Yeah.
But like for a second, he thinks it's cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
You'll take that.
Yeah, I'll take that.
By the time he's 15, he won't even want to associate with
totally,
you, right?
Yeah. So I got to. This is like a. Like,
enjoy this while it's
lately,
there.
Lately, he's been playing T-ball, and I'm not allowed to cheer.
Mm.
So, like, all I want to do is coach him and cheer for him. And if I cheer, he'll go, Mom, no. Shh. No cheering.
Oh, okay.
But, like, the last game, he said, turned to me before his at bat, and he said, if you want, you can cheer this time, but not too loud.
Oh, okay.
So
that's nice. So
we're making progress.
Small
here.
Cheers. Yeah. Small cheers. All right. So six signs you're in a bad restaurant.
Okay.
What was your suggestion there, Momo?
If they take too long to come over after you're seated.
Yeah. This is one of them. You're being ignored.
Yes.
If you're being ignored, you're in a bad restaurant.
Yeah.
Brian, anything come to mind for you?
Have you seen any bugs?
Well, yeah. No, I don't know.
I mean, I've seen cockroaches in a restaurant before, yeah.
Yeah, I know. That kind of goes without saying.
If you sit down at the table and it hasn't been cleaned.
Yes, sticky table is
one
of them.
Sticky table.
Sticky table.
Oh, sticky table or sticky floor.
Sticky,
oh,
sticky floor. Also sticky menus.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Do you ever get the menus where it's, they feel...
You open it up
yeah.
and
yeah, exactly, exactly.
Ew.
This is...
I got one. When they don't refill your water...
That's very annoying.
It's very annoying.
But it doesn't mean I'm in a bad restaurant.
But doesn't mean you're in a bad restaurant necessarily.
You'd be, wouldn't happen in a good restaurant.
To me, if the waiter looks uncleanly, coughing,
yeah, sure,
you know, not really.
This is one that I think is the biggest telltale sign. Dirty bathroom.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
If the bathroom is just a mess, you know nobody's paying attention to it. And if they're not paying attention to that, what else are they not paying attention to?
I agree with that. That is a real, that's really gross.
This is one that I think is interesting.
Yeah.
A 10-page menu.
Okay.
So think about when you go to, do they still have Cheesecake Factory?
Yep.
Yeah, the gigantic menu.
The gigantic menu. So my thought is they can't possibly be good at all of these
That's
things.
Right.
Like, which are the good ones? Because on page 11, there's a crispy fried chicken salad that maybe they don't specialize in, but they're going to throw together somehow. I don't trust a big menu.
I don't know if I want to go with a blanket statement on that one, because we have a sushi restaurant in the Valley.
It's all sushi, different fish and stuff,
yeah,
that's
it's
different.
All different fish. But there's all these, like, you know, you feel like some like different chefs over the years have just come up with different roles. So they have all these random. This is the Carlos role.
But
and
somebody
this is
put
this...
time into that, right?
Yeah. And some of the menu has pictures of the roles, and some doesn't, and it's all kind of mishmash. They have to give you like three separate menus. But it's a really good sushi restaurant.
By the way, photos of the food is one of the things they have signs you're in a bad restaurant.
Oh.
So your place has a big menu and a...
Yeah.
The menu sticky?
Sometimes.
Oh, what are you going there for?
It's really good. It's a really good sushi place.
What's wrong with photos of the food?
Let me go to this and say...
Because I like seeing what the food looks like.
Especially sushi. I want to know what it looks like.
Exactly.
Okay. Restaurants that need pictures instead of words or explanations to describe the food might leave you disappointed. Besides that, there is no way the food that arrives at your table is going to look identical to the image you saw on the menu. Again, if this is a dinner, it gets a pass. But those photos are stock images. The line cook isn't uploading photos from his iPhone or anything.
Oh, come on. This guy sounds bougie. Like, I want to
just it's just a waiter.
I mean, the truth is, if I was in a really like fine dining establishment, I would probably agree with that.
Yeah.
I don't need to see pictures. But if I'm there's certain food places I want to see the picture.
Right.
Like, I want to see the picture of the sushi because they all look a little different.
Yeah.
Is it like extra fishy? Is it more rice? Is it cucumber wrap? Is it like
Right.
I want to know.
Do you consider yourself to be a foodie?
No.
I don't, and I hate the term too.
Yeah, me too. I think it's annoying.
I like food. Is that a foodie?
No.
No, a foodie is like you want capers in it or something.
Capers
Yeah.
Okay, like
if
like
you're
let
pro
me,
caper, you're a foodie.
Okay. Yeah. That's the rules.
Yeah.
If I look up foodie, it says pro caper.
Pro caper.
Like to me, like if do you have an opinion on yuzu?
I don't know what that is.
I don't know what
foodies do.
What is it?
Yuzu?
Yeah, do you like shishito peppers? Yeah,
I do like shishito peppers. Okay, so, remember, there's always one super hot one.
Yeah. Yeah. There's
when
one.
There's yeah. one super and hot shishito it, you're pepper. Like, oh, man, you're like, damn, I got the hot one.
Yeah.
We've all been there.
A friend of mine, do you know who Phil Rosenthal is? He created Everybody Loves Raymond, and now he has a show called Somebody Feed Phil.
Okay, I don't know.
So he travels all over the world, and then he eats the food. And each. And I'm like, how do you get that gig?
Yeah,
that is such a good gig. He is, and I'll just plug this, on the Culture Pop podcast right now. Unbelievably funny guy.
So
unbelievably funny.
I think everyone. So it all started with Bourdain, right?
Yes.
And then the Food Channel, and people have the travel food shows, and yeah, yeah.
Phil says that when he pitched the show, he said, I'm just like Bourdain, except I'm afraid of everything.
Oh, great.
It's a good pitch.
Yeah. So then now Eugene Levy has a show like this.
He has one, yeah.
And Stanley Tucci has
did Searching Italy.
Yeah, Stanley Tucci's like definitely a foodie.
So we got this pitch going. It's we take an athlete to his favorite restaurant and do a conversation.
I like
there.
That.
You like that?
Yeah.
It's a good pitch, right?
It's a good pitch. You shouldn't give it away.
It's out there.
I mean,
it's out there. It's actually being pitched.
Like, you put it on writing and registered.
Correct.
It.
Correct. And it's
great.
It's all good. Out there, and we're looking for a buyer of it.
Good. It's a good show.
Yeah. I think that's fun, right?
Yeah. That feels like perfect, what they call sideline programming.
Yes, exactly.
Sideline programming for the MLB channel.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Going to do some What's Up, Fool. 3 o'clock, Momo.
Oh.
Talks to a real-life television person. Well, you're a real-life television.
Yeah.
But somebody who's in the news business
about doing
the weather on Channel 11. So Alex is going to be coming on.
Do I get the green screen?
You would. Of course you'd get a green screen. Of course you would. All right, so I'm driving now, Momo.
Yeah.
A fantastic, my favorite car I've driven in a really long time. It is the Elantra Hybrid. So I work with Southern California Hyundai dealers. Love these guys. First thing I did when I started my partnership with these guys is I went out and I got a Hyundai. The Elantra, fantastic. Getting 50 miles a gallon. They let me drive the Ioniq 6 for a week. Whew, if you want a long driving range EV and cutting edge technology, this is like... very stylish and futuristic. And, of course, the Sonata is beautiful. If you want an SUV, the Santa Fe is there. This spring, you can get in, get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. And as always, every new Hyundai comes with America's best warranty, 3 years, 36,000 miles of complimentary maintenance. So hurry in today because these great deals are not going to last. Add more joy to every journey at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event going on now. Visit buyhyundai.com or see your SoCal Hyundai dealer today. Mason, Ireland, 710 ESPN.
Hey, I'm Dave Denholm.
And I'm Mario Rees.
You know us from the LAFC radio broadcast.
Now we have a new podcast called LAFC Plus, and you can find it on the ESPN LA app.
LAFC Plus brings you all the latest on the black and gold.
Plus, we break down the latest news and interesting stories from around MLS.
For all the news, fun, insight, and everything that is MLS and LAFC, join us on LAFC Plus.
LAFC!
It's available on the ESPN LA app and everywhere you get your podcasts.
Join us.
Big news, Laker fans. John Ireland here. You can now stream every Lakers game on the ESPN LA app. Don't miss a second of the action with Michael Thompson and I on the call. Plus, all your live and local Lakers talk every day in the palm of your hand.
You're one tap away from everything Lakers.
You could even win Lakers tickets.
Download the ESPN LA app. And bam. Bam.
Download the ESPN LA app at the App Store and Google Play.
Southland, you know what we do each weekday at 2:45. What's up, fool? And we've been very excited that What's Up, Fool is made possible by our friends at Dos Hombres. In fact, we've got a special guest voice. Take it away, guest voice.
What's Up, Fool is brought to you by Dos Hombres Mezcal. It's fate. It's friendship. It's mezcal. Dos Hombres.
Look at that. How do I follow that? I don't. So I simply say, take it away, Corporate Greg.
Thanks, Morales. All right, so I want to know if this has ever happened to you.
Okay.
So I was sitting in with Travis and Sliwa doing Factor Cap. And
I heard this today. Yeah.
And it went, after it was over, I got a phone call. And it was from a friend of a friend.
Friend of a friend.
And so I didn't know what it was for. But so I answered the phone. And he starts talking to me and saying things like, I need to know about the FRG and the 7239, all this stuff. And I said, wait a second. Who do you think you're talking to? And she's like, it's Greg. It was a different Greg.
He called
the wrong Greg. I picked it up because I thought he was going to tell me there was something wrong with my friend. Like, why, that's the only reason he would call me.
Right.
So has anybody ever called you that was meant for somebody else?
Yeah.
And I talked to you about it.
I got a call. I was so offended by this.
Oh.
Got a call, and the guy said, I'm interested in buying some stuff. And I'm like, who is this? He said, I was told by so-and-so that I could buy some stuff from you. I'm like, what kind of stuff do you want to buy? And he said, cocaine. Like, what are you calling me? I'm not a dealer. What?
John Mulaney.
I have no idea. Yeah, no, back in the day. Not now, John.
Not anymore,
John.
Yes.
No, called me and asked for cocaine. I'm like, I don't know how you got my number, why you think I would do this, but he said, wow. Yeah, a guy gave me your number. So if you have my number, don't call me for drugs.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you answered. You never answered.
Back in the day, I used to answer. I never answer my
phone
anymore.
Now you're like, no way.
No, I don't have time.
Momo, have you ever had a friend of a friend call you, but it was meant to be a different Ramona or something?
No, there's no other Ramonas.
You're the only Ramona.
It is a pretty rare name.
Yeah. I mean, it's, you know, like I've done it to other people.
Have you done? Okay. Have you
done? Like just recently. This is a little embarrassing.
Okay, good.
Yeah, always great. So my best friend from elementary school, we're still really close. She lives in San Francisco, and she works at night. So oftentimes when I'm about to go on a walk at night, I will text and be like, hey, are you working tonight or are you off? And so all I just wrote was like, are you working tonight? And her name is Allie. And so I started I just wrote that text. And then a little while ago, why? It's weird she hasn't answered me.
Yeah.
And I realized I sent that to Allison Felix.
Oh,
wow. Oh.
Gold medalist Allison Felix.
Yeah.
So she did not respond to you ever?
I wrote her the next day and said, she's also like 9 months pregnant and was probably asleep. Wow. So saw it in the morning. It's like, sorry, I meant that my other friend, Allie.
Yeah.
Brian, that's a pretty common name.
Yeah.
Has anybody ever called you when you were the wrong Brian?
I don't think so, actually. I've never had that experience.
Sometimes if I text you one-on-one, Brian, my brother Brian is in my phone, so a lot of times he will get texts about pull the sound of such and such for the show, and my brother go wrong Brian again.
I do that actually. I have a really good friend. The friends that used to stay with me that you think just like welched off me.
Oh well, they did.
Yeah, they kind of.
They
did.
They were squatters. Yes, at your apartment.
The wife's name is Laura.
Yep.
So a lot of times I will text Laura Romo.
But
right. I send it to her. Yeah.
Right.
Laura.
Yeah, can you be here at 10 a.m. tomorrow?
Right.
Have you ever done the like embarrassing text, like an autocorrect text to somebody really important?
No. The one thing that I have done is send the text to the completely wrong person.
Oh,
yeah. I meant to.
Sent an unbelievably embarrassing text to one of our MCs.
Last night.
Yeah. And I thought I was texting somebody else. I thought I was texting Juan, and I was texting the MC.
Yeah, he was really cool about
it. Yeah, he knows all my problems now.
My thing, I did that once to Ireland. You and I were texting.
Oh, yeah, you and I were texting.
I sent something to Ireland when I meant to send it to Mason.
Right. It said, don't tell John, I believe.
Oh, gosh.
Tell John.
Oh.
And it went to John. And then John immediately called me. What am I not supposed to know?
But hey, it got you two talking.
It did. It got us talking.
Important.
Exactly. Oh my God. Right. I did one. I'll just tell you.
Okay.
It's so bad.
Yeah.
It was 4 or 5 years ago, and I've since signed another contract, so it didn't you know,
affect you.
Affect me. But I was texting with Jimmy Pitaro, who runs ESPN.
Jimmy Pitaro, yeah.
Yeah, runs ESPN.
Yep.
And we were talking about something. I don't want to say what we were talking about, but it was something.
This is such ESPN a heavy name related. Drop. Okay. Such a heavy name drop.
And I said, okay, sounds good. We'll keep you. And I meant to say looped, but yep. Autocorrect changed it to pooped.
Oh, no.
We'll keep you pooped.
Yeah.
And I said,
so weird when I
immediately, and then he wrote back, I'm excited to be kept pooped.
Yeah.
So I
said,
it.
I always, looped.
By the way, I'm
looped. Come on, autocorrect.
I text with Bob Iger all the time and yeah. never have made a mistake like
Bob
that. Iger is Jimmy Pitaro's boss.
Can you imagine doing that to
I'm one up.
The
I'm
head of
her.
Your company?
So
I'll keep you pooped.
Yeah.
I say to a lot of women in my life, my mom, my brother's wife and all that, I tell you, yes, ma'am. When they say something, I write, yes, ma'am. So to both Lindsay and to Emily, I've done, yes, ma'am, but it got auto-corrected to mama. So I said, yes, mama.
Yes, mama.
To both Lindsay and Emily.
Oh,
yes,
so
mama.
And I'm like, no, I'm sorry. That was auto-correct.
I
don't do that anymore.
Oh, God, okay.
All right, so during one of these breaks here, I was diving more into the woman who caught the Ohtani home run
ball. Yes,
yes. I thought I saw on Twitter, I found the woman who's claiming, Amber24 on Twitter, is claiming she's the one.
Way to go, Amber24.
Caught it.
Yeah.
And people were kind of back and forth in her comments about, oh, you didn't get enough for the autograph. You could have held them ransom. And then there's a lot of people that are like, oh, you did the right thing. It's not your accomplishment.
Right.
You still got signed ball, two signed hats, and a bat. Although she claims she didn't need them either.
She didn't even need those.
Right. No, she got all those things, but didn't meet Ohtani.
Didn't meet him,
it was reported.
Right.
But my question to you guys is, so if you catch, you know, a milestone, home run, ball, whatever that, are you holding that ransom? Are you trying to get, give me $25,000. Here's the ball. How about season tickets? What do you
If I got the Ohtani ball, I would just give it to him.
Me too.
I would not hold the ball hostage.
Yeah.
I mean, he's a nice guy. It's his great first moment at Dodgers. I'm just going to say, here, Shohei. I would like to meet. It would be cool to meet him.
It would.
But I would not hold the ball hostage.
No. Yeah, some of the comments were like, oh, you just burned a lottery ticket kind of a deal.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like you have to do something. I mean, look, if I made an outstanding catch, right? Like if I'm in the field.
Oh, then you'd keep it?
I mean, then I might want to milk it a little bit.
Right.
You know, but I don't think you did anything. You just happened to be sitting there when the ball
Bergman,
came in.
You would just give it back, right?
Nope. Absolutely not. I would ask, they would say, here, can I have this? I'd say, yes, can I have this also? And then keep going. As long as
but
they keep saying yes.
What would be your price?
And when they stop saying yes.
That's a good
idea. Once they say no, then I'm like, okay, cool, I'm good.
So tell me the order of things you would ask
here,
for.
How about a ball?
Okay,
sure. Yeah, that's great. Can I have a bat too?
A bat?
Yeah, sure. Okay, how's some tickets?
Tickets?
Sure,
okay,
tickets.
Yeah.
Okay, how about some batting gloves?
Okay.
Yeah. You can. Okay. Cool. Can I meet Shohei? No.
Nope.
Okay. Cool. I'm done.
What about? Can you meet Ipe?
Yeah. I need some bets.
Can I meet Ipe?
I can put
that
on.
That would be a different story.
Right
that
now, that would make be. Some really good bets.
Yeah, I would be looking for tickets right away.
Yeah.
Tickets. Tickets is the right way.
It's the yes and until you get to know.
Yeah. Got it. All right. So coming up next, Momo. I don't know if you guys know this or not, but Momo has a driving passion in her life. It is to do the weather. And the one person I know that can help make that happen is my friend Alex Michelson from Channel 11. He's my we go to all the USC games together. We'll talk to him next and hopefully get you in front of the old blue screen, Momo. Hopefully.
I gotta practice right now.
Yeah,
you gotta. I'm looking up the weather.
Okay, good. Yeah, practice for him. We'll do that coming up next for you. Mason, Ireland, 710 ESPN.
710 ESPN. Don't get it twisted, yo. The most downloaded sports radio show in Los Angeles. The podcast, that is.
Mason and Ireland, the number one most downloaded sports podcast in Los Angeles. The number one most downloaded sports podcast in Los Angeles. And we thank all of our podcast listeners for that.
If you ever miss a moment, get your fill anytime. Just search Mason and Ireland wherever you get your podcast.
So, Momo loves the weather, loves it, and has always wanted...
I was kind of born to do it.
Yeah, you've always wanted to do it on TV in a real way, right?
Yeah.
And the one guy I know that can make that happen is Alex Michelson from Fox 11. Alex, what are you doing, man?
It is great to be with you. Long-time listener, first-time caller. Big fan of the show for so many years, and it's great to be with you on ESPN Radio.
Cool, man. So Momo here, you know she has a burning desire to do the weather.
I know.
So Momo, pitch yourself as the guest weather person for you're on at 5, 6, and 10:30 on Friday nights, right?
5, 6, and 10 every night, and then the issue is our political show is on Friday nights at 10:30.
Got it. Okay. So, Momo, pitch yourself.
Here's the thing, Alex. I have grown up on the Weather Channel. Like, when I was 4 years old, the first thing I did in the morning was turn on the Weather Channel and tell my mom what the weather was going to be like so we would know what to wear to school. I was the weather girl for our team in college, and it was my responsibility to follow the weather, track the radar, and just make the call of whether we needed to tarp the field or not the night before.
Right.
This was a big responsibility because nobody wanted to spend the time to put the tarp on and then show up early to take it off. And if I made us do it and then it didn't rain, then people would get mad at me. But if I said, we don't have to put it on, and it did rain, we were going to get rained out. It was a big thing, and I took it very seriously.
Sure.
I would come home from practice, and I would study the radar.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I didn't just rely on whatever the Weather Channel said or Weather Underground. I have wind alert on my phone.
Oh, my God.
I mean, I know all the wind tunnels.
You're like a weather nerd.
Total nerd.
Weather nerd.
Total nerd.
So is there a place for somebody like Momo at Channel 11,
and
Alex?
I know all the verbiage, right? Like, I can do it off the top of my head.
Wow.
I mean, can you give us a little bit of a sample forecast of what we should expect tonight?
Yeah, well, I think tonight is going to be an interesting night because it's very cool overnight in all the mountains and valleys. We actually might see snowfall down to about 4,000 feet. So it's a good time if you want to take that last bit of spring break to head up to Big Bear and get some snow. Good time to go up to the mountains. Just leave on the early side because the snow might come overnight and you don't want to drive in the snow. You want to wake up to it. Now, down in the valleys, make sure you got your plants covered. Anything that might be frost warnings, it's out and about for the whole rest of the weekend. I know we thought it was spring earlier in the week, but it's transitioned back to winter. We got one more last gasp. Record rainfall the last couple of years. We might get another chance of showers, 35% on Friday overnight. But hopefully by the weekend, it should clear up and we'll be on to spring finally.
Wow.
Oh, my God. Wow.
Just off the top of my head.
That was like a weather masterpiece.
It's pretty good, right?
We just had the Golden Mike Awards in Southern California this past weekend, and Dallas Rains won for weather forecast
as he should.
But I think there's a new contender. And
what do you think?
Dallas has been doing this for almost 40 years. That's like your first forecast like this. And
I can just do it off the top of my head.
Almost anybody.
Yeah.
This is, you're like a savant.
Yes.
I think it's because I have literally watched so many hours of the Weather Channel and Dallas and Johnny Mountain and all the guys over the years who've done it that I know the surf warning. I get weather alerts.
Now, Alex, I don't know if you know this or not, but did you know that Dallas Rance, who won a gold mic, was a backup quarterback for Florida State back in the day? Did you know that?
No.
I did know that. I used to work there with him, and he was a big Bobby Bowden guy because of that. Because of his connection to Florida State, and they had a good relationship. But Dallas, as much as he knows about weather, he knows that much about college football.
Yeah.
He, like, loves talking about college football, especially quarterbacks, because of that reason.
Well, I think the key to good weather reporting, and this is because I've watched the local casters. It's not if you just watch the Weather Channel, they don't really humanize it. They don't really make it about what you might be doing this weekend. You know, or what it's been going on in your neck of the woods, right? That's totally a weather phrase. Your neck of the woods.
Your neck of the woods, yeah. That's a Today Show thing, right?
Totally.
Yeah, Al Roker.
Al Roker, yeah.
But you have to personalize it. So you have to think, okay, everybody's on spring break.
Sure.
What they might be doing for the weekend.
Yeah, no, I think
what's
it's magic.
Been going on.
I think it's magical the way you did the weather there. Now, is there a spot for her, Alex?
Yes, I've been saying this for a long time. We need Ramona to come in.
Got
to
make it happen.
I've said to you, give me a date. We'll do it.
Yeah.
We could do it next week if you want to do it. Come on in.
Got to make it happen.
Steve, as I know you just referred to it as the blue screen. It is the green screen.
Oh,
see, at home, we've got a blue screen. We've got a blue screen and a green screen opposite sides. So
do
it's
those
a green
guys,
screen.
Do they, see, now the thing is, that's interesting. Do those guys write their, I'm like grinning. I'm literally grinning right now.
No.
Do those guys write their report out or do they just freelance? Do they just go?
No, it's the only thing in the show where there's no teleprompter.
Good.
Because the way that the camera works, the teleprompter goes off and it flips to a monitor so you can see yourself in the green screen.
Got it.
So it helps you guide in terms of where to go. Have you ever done that? Have you ever done the green screen thing?
No.
Oh.
I might need a little practice.
That's going to be the fun part of it.
Yeah, that will be fun. That will be fun.
I'll be pointing at the deserts and we're talking about the mountains.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's
exactly.
Little,
So,
yeah,
Alex, in your
we've
world.
We've got a great weather guy named Jonathan Novak who works with us.
Okay.
And he can help teach you with that, and we can have the two of you together. We can do a little bit, maybe talk a little Lakers, talk a little Dodgers, whatever you want.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I think this is going to happen.
All right, we're going to make this happen.
News.
I got to do
awesome.
It.
Yeah.
I got to do it when. We're gonna pick the right day when there's some. If it's just 72 and sunny, that's not that exciting.
Well, no, because it's you, it's your personality,
it's you showing.
I mean, no, you don't necessarily want to be on the heavy weather.
I like it when there's stuff
happening. Like storm watch and stuff like that.
Storm watch.
I don't think you're ready for storm watch.
I'm ready for storm.
No, I don't think you're ready
for
storm watch.
Storm watch.
No, I don't think you're there yet. So, Alex, we were talking a little bit earlier today about Larry David says he wants to get rid of goalposts in football. He wants to get rid of field goals and kickers. How do you feel about that?
I mean, I think that makes sense. Who's watching the game for the kicker, right? And why is this game coming down to a kicker?
You're watching
the game for the quarterback. You're watching the game for the defense. That's what it's all about. So why should this one person who doesn't even really practice with the rest of the team, who has their own sort of shtick and barely even had a guard on their helmet years ago, be the thing that determines the outcome of the game? I agree with Larry David.
Yeah.
Football, I mean, it is really the only foot part of football, so I guess that part.
Oh, that's a good point.
That's true.
But so it's kind of in the name, but besides that, I would much
rather. Why is it called football?
Yeah, I don't know.
That's
I
a good
mean,
question.
But
that feels like a whole bit.
I'd rather the game come down to Patrick Mahomes versus Harrison Butker kick.
Yeah, totally. See, I think it comes down to something really dramatic, and I'm okay with that. By the way, I think I'm the only one here that wants to keep kickers.
Time to jump off the
They
island.
Just want to bounce kickers altogether.
Time to fold. It's not too late to grab the folding chair.
Yeah. So, Alex, how big a deal in your world is the arrival of Shohei Ohtani?
I think it's a huge deal. I mean, it's a huge deal as a Dodger fan, but I think it's also a huge deal as sort of a news person who loves the intersection of news and sports because he makes every game a cultural event.
Yep.
I mean, look at what he's doing with the country of Japan and how many Dodger fans are now coming from Japan. I think they were saying something like 11% of people on opening day were people that came from the country
it's
of
amazing.
Japan.
It's amazing.
To watch him.
Yeah.
So you see this whole cross-cultural exchange that's really interesting and changing the way the world views baseball and Los Angeles. I think he's just a phenomenon that's reigniting interest in the sport, which is just great. I mean, what we're seeing, I think you're seeing this as well with women's basketball, with Caitlin Clark and what's happening there right now. You know, sports is so driven by stars. And it's amazing that one person, we saw this with golf all those years ago with Tiger Woods, one person can completely change the landscape of sports. And Shohei is that sort of once-in-a-generation talent, and we're lucky to be watching him in L.A. along with so many other once-in-a-generation talents. I mean, Shohei comes here, and Mookie Betts has shown him up.
Yeah.
An even better start.
You know, to put that into some perspective, Todd Boehly, who's one of the owners of the Dodgers, I think he owns like 20% or 25% or something like that, he points out that 9 million people watched the 5 World Series game last year. They averaged, they averaged about 9 million people. 70 million people worldwide watched Ohtani's introductory press conference. That is insane. Wow. 70 million people watch that.
And how many people watch the NCAA tournament prediction show?
I don't. Oh, 5 million. 5 million watch the NCAA tournament. Yeah, I mean, well, the World Series is about 9 million, and Shohei was. I mean, that is a ton of eyeballs, and it's introducing the Dodgers. They're an international brand now.
Well, they already were,
right?
And now it's just over.
Yeah.
Like, it's just they're the team. And they don't have Ohtani. They have Yamamoto, too.
Yeah, right.
And isn't it also just a reminder of the power of the Dodger brand? Because Shohei Ohtani was playing down the freeway, you know, for the last few years. And a lot of love for the Angels. We all love that organization. But it just isn't the Dodgers in the way that the Clippers are just not the Lakers. And there are these signature teams that translate around the world in a different way, and you see Shohei being treated differently now that he's in that Dodger blue.
You mentioned, like, do you hate the Clippers as much as I do?
I don't hate the Clippers, no. But I like the Clippers, but I am not, I don't think they're rivals with the Lakers, because let's see them play each other in the Western Conference Finals, and then let's see the Clippers win 17 titles, and then maybe we can have a conversation.
Exactly.
They're not on equal ground. People that treat them like they're on equal ground, it's not anywhere close. When you go to crypto.com arena and you see the statues and you see the jerseys and you see all that, you know, and then you think about the Clippers and they don't have one thing there. I mean, I think the Clippers franchise should change their name when they go to Inglewood and
be smart.
Start a brand new thing, be the Hollywood Stars or be something else.
Have you been inside that new building?
I haven't. I've seen it, but it looks unbelievable.
It looks crazy. It is so big. I mean, it's just a hulking big building. I've not been inside. Shinato has been inside. He says it's just going to blow everybody's mind.
Wow. They got this wall that's supposed to be, like, straight up. Like, the idea is that it's going to feel like the old Oakland Coliseum felt for the Warriors, right?
Right.
Oracle. Where the
it's going to be all Clipper fans.
Yeah, it's like the slope, like, really steep, and then it'll create this wall of noise.
Yeah.
I don't know. It just feels kind of steep.
And there's great bathrooms, according to Steve Ballmer. Yeah.
Bathrooms!
Lots of bathrooms.
Yeah, you love the bathrooms there.
It's all like you show your card when you walk in there.
Yeah.
And you don't have to pull out your wallet. You can just walk over there and take it because it's scanning you.
Toilets!
I know.
But to that point about, like, stars, though, you know, Kawhi Leonard, one of the great players that we've seen in the last 20 years in the NBA, has such little charisma off the court. That there is not that connection to him that there is to other people. And he, you know, doesn't engender that sort of feeling, you know, making everybody like you have to watch the Clippers right now. And, you know, that's a problem for them. I mean, they don't have that LeBron James figure that means you got to look at the Clippers and you feel for them because that franchise has been cursed for so long, and nobody did a better job of explaining that than Ramona Shelburne and her incredible podcast and movie to come and all the rest of it with Donald Sterling. You hope they can get over the hump, but, you know, you feel like they're not quite there yet.
Yeah. So I got a question. This is just a totally random question. You ready? So the New York Yankees have, you know, they're always very strict about their facial hair and all that stuff. So Alex Verdugo, who started in the Dodgers organization, went Red Sox and now to the Yankees, always wore multiple chains. And the Yankees have imposed a chain cap of one. He's only allowed to wear one chain.
A chain cap.
Now, how many chains am I wearing, Momo?
Two.
Two. I think he should be allowed to wear as many chains as he wants. Alex, what do you think?
Unlimited chains.
Yes. Unlimited chains.
Why do you have two chains?
As long as you're performing.
Yeah, as long as you're out there. I was saying to Bergman today, Mookie's got two. Well, he's got a chain, and then he's got the little baseball guy on a chain around his neck. So he's got two.
Is it why is it your – why do you have two chains?
It's my signature move.
Oh, okay.
The two chains, yeah.
Okay.
A lot of people know me for that.
Can you describe the two chains for people that are listening in the radio and not seeing them?
One is, we are on YouTube too, but there's a long kind of Cuban, this is a Cuban style chain.
Okay.
And this is one from Abdul, one of our regular listeners. Who gave me, this is like a ball
Looks
chain.
Good.
Yeah. So I'm right. Also, Cappy wears two chains. I just want to say Alex Verdugo should not have a chain cap in New York.
I think you can institute whatever you want.
Exactly.
No, I'm actually on the Yankee side on this.
No, you're not.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. You want to cap the number of chains a player can wear?
It's like their thing. Like the no facial hair and the Yankees need to look
a certain
way.
But the chain thing is brand new. I think there's somebody just making this up as they go. All right, and we also only allow one chain.
Well, because chains can get out of hand. I mean, you know, you could say two is not a big deal, but then what happens if we get to four, five?
Well, I'm okay with a three-chain cap.
Well, see, that's still a cap.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like a hard cap or a no cap. You got to have an uncapped league or a hard cap league.
So, Alex, let's do this for real with Momo, huh?
All right.
I
got
to
pick a right
spot.
We really
want to do it with Momo. We got to be, it's going to be a big thing. It's going to be a big viral moment. We're excited.
Do it after. I'm on vacation next week, so do it the week after.
Okay.
Do it the week after.
We'll do it like during that play-in tournament because they'll get busy with the playoffs. But like during that first week, they'll be good.
Yep. All right. Hey, Alex, great having you. Come on, man. You can watch Alex at 5, 6, 10, and at 10:30 every Friday night is The Issue Is. Thanks, man, for coming on.
Thank you, guys. I love both of you. This is really fun.
Cool. All right. There's Alex Munderson.
It's your buddy.
You're going to be...
I'm excited about this.
A bright spotlight for this. People are going to watch. It's going to live on social media.
I better not suck.
Do you know what you're going to... You've got
to
wear...
No, I have to pick out something to wear.
A weather forecasty kind of thing.
You know, I got to study the female weathercasters.
You think?
Yeah. Is that like a pantsuit situation?
I don't keep track. You might know.
Is it like a... I mean, most of them are guys.
No, there are a lot.
There are some female ones.
Yeah, no, there. Maria Caban has been at Channel 11 for years.
I gotta go look up some inspiration.
Good Day LA. Olga Spina, I see all the time. She's great.
Okay.
No, there are a lot. All right, coming up next for you, I find this to be just an absolutely embarrassing story. Absolutely embarrassing for Major League Baseball. Just the worst possible scenario you could have for a Major League Baseball team.
Oh.
That is coming up next. Mason and Ireland, 710 ESPN.
Black and gold are back at home for a battle at BMO.
Absolutely electric to live and die in Los Angeles.
But it's not just any battle. It's a battle for Los Angeles.
It's the game in MLS. It's always the game in Major League Soccer when these two teams meet.
The fiercest rivalry in MLS. LAFC and Galaxy face off in downtown LA.
We expect nothing less than 90-plus minutes of amazing football.
Coverage begins Saturday at 4 p.m. on 710 ESPN and the ESPN LA app.
All right, Parker.
What's up, Greg?
Spring training. All right, Parker. Jeez.
Little Ohtani and Dodger blue.
Yeah, why are you looking at the camera?
I don't know. Let's start over. All right, Parker. Dodger spring training.
That's right, Greg. Ohtani and Dodger blue.
Yeah, Yamamoto's here. Pretty excited about that one.
Tons of new faces. I mean, Kike's back.
Yes, it's great. Maybe we should talk about it on the ESPN LA YouTube channel.
I like that idea. What do you say? 9:30, 9:55?
Right, leading right into Travis Sliwa. Get a couple guests.
Maybe Marcus Grant, Travis Rogers, perhaps?
Yep, just have a bunch of people come in. Maybe Clinton Yates will even find his way in.
Oh, you know, you always want to have the handsome man president right there.
Absolutely. All right, well, I think we should do that. We'll do it every day, Monday through Friday, 9:30 to 9:55 on the ESPN LA YouTube channel. Thanks to LAX.
And it is Mason in Ireland on 710 ESPN, the OGs of LA Sports Radio. We're here each weekday, 1 to 4 p.m. for your afternoon. Sandwiched between Travis and Sliwa and Sonato and Cap. Mason in Ireland continues now.
Juan thinks it's ridiculous that I'm wearing 2 Chainz.
It's not ridiculous.
I think they're nice.
They're nice.
It's kind of a signature thing. What do you think, Burger?
The thing is that, I mean, first of all, I don't think you're a chain guy.
I am a chain guy.
No, now you are.
That's what they say about me, chain guy.
I understand that you made it a bit for the radio.
Yeah.
The fact is, you wear it at home, too.
I do. I wear them all the time. These are my 2 lucky chains. Everywhere I go.
But you can't, nobody can see them.
No, like, they're for me. Sometimes you see them. Like if I do another button, then you got that.
Oh, yeah.
There we go. This is like
the
Chris
Morales
move.
Yeah,
the Chris Morales move is like this, holding it open.
Like if we're on YouTube, put them out so we can all see them so we can see them.
Judge me.
Judge you, yes.
So you can judge me.
Well, but if they're, I mean, you're doing this whole chain thing.
I can feel you judging me right now.
I'm always judging
you. Yes, you are. I think 2 is really the limit.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't go more than 2.
See, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. 2 is, I think 2 is a good cap for me.
4 chain.
I've got 2 more chains.
Put them on.
Maybe I'll put them on after vacation.
Yeah. By the way, Bergman, I have a little tip for you. I know you've been talking about this Pilates date.
Oh, you have a Pilates date?
Oh, yeah, I'm going next Wednesday, yeah.
Have you been to Pilates at all yet?
No,
oh,
never.
Wow.
I have to get socks.
Listen,
I just found out.
No, I just need to warn you. I have done Pilates. I have a nickname for that particular exercise.
Okay.
It's called Fartilates.
I honestly don't think I farted in 2 months.
So go to the bathroom before you go in there.
Yeah, every pose is just a big farter.
Is it worse than yoga?
Yeah, way worse.
But yoga,
like happy baby,
there's that happy baby.
Happy baby, you go and fart.
Happy baby is fart pose.
Yes.
Yeah, but like all of Pilates is.
And so,
like every move in Pilates, you're like, oh man, I just hold it in.
I'm the only male in there too, yeah. Probably. So
just don't have any dairy for like 2 days before you go.
Okay, so actually,
by the way, Bergman,
it's
I would not worry about this that much.
I'm not, but
I think you'll be okay. Actually, I was looking for that. We played yesterday that Dan Orlovsky sound. Do you have the Dan Orlovsky? Did you? I don't know if you heard this or not, Mo.
No.
Okay, now I'm going to play it for you. I will not tell you my theory until after we play.
All right.
Do you have it?
Did you get it, Brian?
Oh.
Yeah, he got it.
Okay. Here we go.
It's impossible to be at the top at both of those, essentially. Like,
Now,
what?
My theory.
What
do you think of that? Do you think that's real?
No.
What do you think it was?
Because he didn't even pause. Like, if you did that while you were on the air, there would be like a part of you that's like, you know, like,
oops.
He didn't even break.
He never
stride.
Stopped talking. In fact, if you listen a little longer, listen to it a little longer.
To be at the top at both of those, essentially, like it's
that sounds like an airplane.
Another farting Dan Orlovsky situation.
Dan.
Just took place.
Danny Dumps.
You just farted into the
Danny Dumps.
What do you mean? It's unbelievable.
He's continuing to make his point.
Yeah.
Trying to ignore what happened. So
he's on with McAfee.
Yes, he's on with McAfee.
That sounds like McAfee.
Okay. So
that didn't even really sound like a fart.
I think they planted this.
Yeah.
I think they did Dan dirty.
Yep.
They made it. They played a sound effect and then they blamed him for it.
They called him Danny Dumps.
Danny Dumps.
Dang, man.
Because apparently he farted on a Monday Night Football one time.
But that was real.
That was real.
That was real. This is not real. This is like...
That's embarrassing.
That's like a whoopee cushion.
He says that it was his windshield wipers on like a dry... Like he must have hit the windshield wiper.
One more time. Listen to the wipers.
It's impossible to be at the top at both of those, essentially. Like
that
it's
is not a windshield wiper.
I mean, it could be.
Well, was he driving?
Dry.
Like,
yeah,
why
he was
he
sitting in his car.
He's sitting in his car doing a phoner with McAfee.
You're not supposed to do a phoner like that.
Well, I mean, I think Orlovsky's on all the time. He's just sitting in his car with a phone.
With a FaceTime?
Yeah, with a FaceTime situation.
I mean,
exactly.
I've done that when I couldn't make it home in time for a hit or something, or they called me and it was breaking news. But
yeah,
generally speaking, you don't keep your wipers on.
No, the wipers are not.
You got to turn the car
McAfee
off.
McAfee played a sound effect and made it seem like he farted.
Listen, I have done radio interviews while I'm in the car.
Yep.
And you can hear I'm driving sometimes.
Sure.
But if you're doing a FaceTime, you can't drive. And then
Correct.
You definitely should turn the car off. Like, it will be 120 degrees, right?
Right.
In the car by the time of the end of that hit. And I'm sweating.
Right.
But you can't have the car on because then they can hear the car. You can't have your air conditioning on.
Right, exactly.
Because you can hear it on the air.
Right. Well,
you got to be a television professional.
I think it was a setup.
I did too.
I think it was
right.
absolutely
like
a
whoopee
setup.
Cushion, like yeah. someone going into the microphone with a whoopee
with
cushion.
With a whoopee cushion, yeah. or just you know hitting the sound. I mean,
or just what did like the you know you put yeah. it on your hand. No, that was
that was. Do it. So okay,
kind of.
Yeah, that's good.
What was that?
That was a real one.
That was a
sound
yeah,
effect.
Yeah.
I was going to say, nobody did that.
Where's Wendy Williams when we need her?
Yeah, exactly. All right, so I wanted
be
to
careful,
get,
Bergman.
Wanted
no,
to get
what
to
do you
one
mean, Fartilatis?
One more Fartilatis. Thing. One more thing in this segment. The Oakland A's have announced that they... Now, at some point, excuse me. At some point...
That's great.
At the age of 20... In the year 2028, the A's are supposed to be playing in Vegas. Supposed to be.
Why? What is this delay? Like, when you move, you're just supposed to move.
Well, I think part of the problem is Vegas is sort of not wanting them.
Yeah, I know the drama here, okay? So they want to build it over by where the Tropicana used to be.
Right. Didn't they just tear down the Tropicana?
Yeah, the Trop's down. And
yeah.
that's where the new stadium is supposed to be. And the mayor of Vegas, she doesn't want it there because did you know that that area is not actually Las Vegas? It's not under her control.
Really?
She would like the stadium to be in downtown by Fremont Street.
Okay.
And also... A, so that they can get the tax revenue, et cetera.
Right.
But also because there's too much traffic on the strip anyway.
Yeah, there's
If you build a baseball yeah. ballpark right there, it's just going to make everything even worse. That's like one of the most congested areas of the strip.
Yeah, sure.
So it just doesn't work where they want to build it.
Okay. So while this drama is
Carolyn
playing out.
Carolyn something is her name.
Yeah, while this drama is playing out, there is a plan that the Oakland A's will play in Sacramento For, is it for 2 years?
Approved. I think it's
25 to 27.
Is it official 25 yeah. to 27?
Yep. Possibility of 28.
In a 14,000 seat stadium.
It's the Giants minor league stadium.
What an embarrassment.
The Giants AAA affiliate. That's
they,
so embarrassing.
They should take this franchise away from that guy.
Yeah.
Do you realize, I was curious today about the baseball team salaries. How much do you think the A's have spent on their team?
$43 million. $60 million.
The next highest is $85 million. So they're $25
wow.
million
Under.
Less than any other team in
so
the league.
So bad, yeah.
And I don't understand why there's not a salary floor.
Right.
Like there should be a floor. Like you have to spend at least this much to be a credible baseball team.
Yeah, that should be in the CBA.
That should be in the CBA. Because the A's, whoever that owner, I forget who the owner is, but he is getting the revenue, the collective balance
I
tax
say it's
money.
John Fisher, but I don't want to be wrong.
He's getting all that money, the
yeah.
sharing
John
money.
Fisher.
John yeah. Fisher.
Okay, I was right.
So here he is. We don't know if there's going to be a team in
I
Vegas
know.
Or not. It's going to sit in Sacramento for a couple of years.
But
in a 14,000
seat stadium.
Think
about all the team
stadium.
Employees, okay? So you're an employee of the Oakland A's.
Yeah.
So for the next 3 years, you have to move 90 miles to Sacramento.
Yep.
Which is not close to Oakland. It's an hour. It's like 90 miles.
Yeah.
It's like driving from here to San Diego. For 2 years. And then you got to move to Vegas if they'll still have you.
Right.
Like, what and then you have no I think it's seen as a play for Sacramento to prove it can be a major league city.
Yeah, right.
You know, I guess people
well,
in Sacramento
well, it's mostly a play for the A's, right? Cuz the A's are like, well, nobody's going to come to our games here. They're empty. They're protesting in the parking lot.
Yeah.
Why would we even keep the team here? Why not go to a cozy little minor league ballpark for a couple of years and play out
cuz you're not
the
a minor league team.
Right, exactly. 14,000 seats. It's a little bit like when the Chargers went to play at StubHub.
Yeah, that's right.
Small, right? Isn't it called
Dignity Health
down there.
Yeah.
StubHub. They went there even though
it was basically a soccer stadium.
It was a soccer stadium and they played the NFL games there.
I forgot about that.
Yeah. Yeah, that was
embarrassing.
It was embarrassing. And there were no Charger fans in the entire thing.
Still no Charger fans.
Yeah, except for Brian. Brian's over there.
One
very lonely.
Did you ever go to the StubHub Center?
I never did. Nope.
Have you been to SoFi to see the Chargers?
Not the Chargers, nope.
Do you like that I'm making this motion?
Yeah, I like that.
I don't know what that is.
This is like, golly gee, my team.
Throwing shade while you're...
Are you optimistic about this year, Brian?
Oh, yeah, especially after them hardball rules came out.
Oh, the hardball rules.
Yeah.
He's got 14 rules printed on the back of his business card.
Really? Yeah. On the back of his... It's hard to fit 14 things in the back
of his
business
card. I don't know how
card.
He does it. I would
6
like
and
see,
11.
I would like to see a Jim Harbaugh
business card.
Somebody
have a copy of those rules? Send me a copy of those rules.
Oh, I'll send you a copy.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, coming up next for you, Momo... The worst MVP of all time?
Oh.
That's coming up next. Mason, Ireland, 710 ESPN. So if you are trapped in debt and you're up all night, you're worried, how am I going to pay this? How am I going to get out of this hole? You can't get away from it. Truth is, this whole system is designed to trap you in debt. They got insanely high interest credit cards and loans, make it impossible to pay it all off. There's a brand new way out of the debt trap. It is Pivotal Debt Solutions. Now, they're not like the old school debt relief companies that string out your debt for years and years. They have got aggressive new strategies that can end your debt faster and easier than you thought possible. Pivotal Debt Solutions. Now, get this. Think about this. If you're sitting on debt right now, they can cut or even eliminate interest. Bam. Find programs to write off your balances so you owe less. So right off the bat, eliminate interest, you owe less. They can stop the threatening phone calls. No bankruptcy, no loan. The bottom line is they find every solution possible to end your debt permanently. Before you do anything, contact Pivotal Debt Solutions first. You can talk to them for free. Find out how they can help you get out of that debt hole. Visit zapmydebt.com. That's Z-A-P. Zapmydebt.com. Zapmydebt.com. Mason in Ireland. Momo in for John. 710 ESPN.
Hey, I'm Dave Denholm.
And I'm Mario Rees.
You know us from the LAFC radio broadcast.
Now we have a new podcast called LAFC Plus. And you can find it on the ESPN LA app.
LAFC Plus brings you all the latest on the black and gold.
Plus, we break down the latest news and interesting stories from around MLS.
For all the news, fun, insight, and everything that is MLS and LAFC, join us on LAFC Plus.
LAFC!
It's available on the ESPN LA app and everywhere you get your podcasts.
Join us.
Black and gold are back at home for a battle at BMO.
Absolutely electric to live and die in Los Angeles.
But it's not just any battle. It's a battle for Los Angeles.
It's the game in MLS. It's always the game in Major League Soccer when these two teams meet.
The fiercest rivalry in MLS. LAFC and Galaxy face off in downtown LA.
We expect nothing less than 90 plus minutes of amazing football.
Coverage begins Saturday at 4 p.m. on 710 ESPN and the ESPN LA app.
Twisted, yo. The most downloaded sports radio show in Los Angeles. The podcast, that is.
Based in Ireland, the number one most downloaded sports podcast in Los Angeles. The number one most downloaded sports podcast in Los Angeles. And we thank all of our podcast listeners for that.
If you ever miss a moment, get your fill anytime. Just search Mason and Ireland wherever you get your podcast.
So remember in 2008, Apple released the iPhone. Changed everybody's lives, right? Now they are working on creating personal robots. Now, okay. Do you have any interest, Momo, in having a personal robot?
So you're hitting me right in a vulnerable spot.
Yep.
Because I have a fear of Skynet and the AI.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah.
But I also could That's really use say. Somebody to help me with stuff.
Like a personal assistant.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I would love a personal robot.
Yeah.
Go pick up the dry cleaning personal robot.
That'd be kind of good.
Run the vacuum personal robot.
Take over my life and kill me later.
Right,
robot.
See, this is...
this is. Yeah. I'm telling you, there is so much unfounded... Just because James Cameron made Terminator, all of a sudden everybody is quoting Skynet and saying they're all coming to get us, when meanwhile, robot. My personal assistant, Ipe, is going to be very helpful to me.
You're going with Ipe.
Yeah, his name is going to be Ipe.
He's going to help you on cut,
I just
too.
Don't want... I mean, you have to give them everything. You have to give them all your passwords.
Correct.
You have to give them all access to everything.
Correct.
And like that New York Times thing last year where they got the AI guy interacted with the robot and got him to say like all those bad things and scary things. Kind of let me know it's just not there yet. Like, I don't think AI is really there yet. I don't think they've kind of built
tell
it
you
enough.
No, I think AI is there. And if you're not using it, it's screwing you.
I'm not using it.
You're not using it. You are.
How am I using it?
How are you? Well, you don't believe Mike Robin drafted by computer.
I don't believe he did.
I do. I'll tell you this brief story. So I've had for the last 5 years a sound engineer work on the Culture Pop podcast.
Okay.
And we liked it. His quality was really good. The sound was really good. And we paid him. And all of a sudden, we realized you can just drop those files into AI and come up with a better mix of audio than our sound engineer was doing.
Really?
So he was literally replaced by AI. AI did
Do
a better job
Do you feel good about
than
that?
He's still working for us. He's doing all the social media stuff. So he didn't lose his job entirely, but we don't need a sound engineer anymore. If you're not harnessing AI to your advantage, you're not.
I tried doing it once. I was like, okay, let's see what this ChatGPT does.
You never did ChatGPT?
I tried it once. I was doing a story on Josh Harris, who owned the Sixers and the Commanders and all that, and I wanted to see if AI could help me do some research because he had a long business background that I wanted to read up on, and I just figured it would save me a couple hours of reading stuff.
And it didn't work?
Not really. The stuff it found was generic. Like, I really needed to read it myself. I needed to go and do the deep dive myself.
Who is Ramona Shelburne? Hang on.
I don't think it heard you.
Yeah. Who's Ramona Shelburne?
This is great. Thank
you. Ramona Shelburne is a sports journalist and reporter known for her work covering the NBA, particularly the Los Angeles Lakers. She's been involved in reporting on various sports stories and has contributed to ESPN's coverage of basketball.
Is she good at her job?
Ramona Shelburne is highly regarded in the sports journalism industry for her expertise and insightful coverage, especially in basketball. Oh. Many people appreciate her reporting and analysis.
What's the worst part of Ramona Shelburne?
Oh, gosh.
It's subjective, but some people may criticize aspects of her reporting or analysis. However, opinions on journalists can vary widely, so it's important to consider multiple perspectives.
Do you never use this for... Now, that's the talking version. I use the writing version all the time.
I mean, I think it's okay, but like, how hard is it to find that I report on basketball?
Well, you can do more stuff on there.
Okay.
You can do more stuff on
there. I was a little afraid of the negative
thing. I will occasionally...
I was like, oh God, what's going to happen here?
I will occasionally use some ChatGPT in my game. And for Game of Games.
Occasionally, really?
Just to help it.
just to help it, not the whole. You could say write a game about X, and it would write the game. An entire quiz. So I use it to find specific things, but not to write the game itself.
Like when I looked up the stuff on Josh Harris, what I really wanted to read was in his business career, I knew that there had been, I for some reason I thought he was sort of involved in the Enron. I was wrong about that. I thought that they made a lot of money on fracking.
Okay.
That's what I'd read someplace.
All right.
And I really needed to understand that. And I tried to get ChatGPT to, like, look all that stuff up. And it just, the stuff was, like, the way it distilled it was not helpful. I had to just really dig in and read it myself.
Well, it's not going to write the article for you.
I know, but, like, in terms of finding me, I wanted it to find, like, 5 or 6 articles about it. And it didn't really do that. Okay. I was like, I don't know.
I want to do one more
thing.
Super
generic.
Because I teased this.
All right.
Gilbert Arenas on his, I think it's on his podcast.
He's got a show on FUBU.
I think he was on with Shannon Sharp.
Oh, so he's on Club Shay Shay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Club Shay Shay.
Okay, so listen to what he said.
Now, I do understand when they say this about Jokic. Jokic is probably statistically, when it comes to overall game, the worst MVP winner. He's the worst MVP winner in the last 40 years.
What is he talking about?
Statistically, he's the best
MVP
winner.
The best MVP winner.
Like his whole, like one of the biggest arguments for him is statistically.
What do you?
The analytics nerds love Jokic.
Oh, for me, he is the best basketball player in the world right now. I don't think there's any stopping him or slowing him down. He does exactly what he wants to.
Analytically, he is the best.
Yeah.
Like statistically, he's the best.
No, his passing, he's just his footwork. I can't understand what Gilbert Arenas is talking about.
He's not basing it on facts. Like, he's basing it on when you look at him, he does not look like an athletic, physical specimen guy, right? Like, he's not Giannis.
Yeah, but I'm a big results guy. The results are pretty damn good.
And he won a title.
And he won a title,
It took me a while to jump on board that he's the best player in the league train, okay?
Yeah.
Because I felt like he hadn't won, and a couple of the years that he won the MVP, His team finished lower in the standings than they did the year before.
Right.
And I thought a lot of the argument for him was like, oh, Jamal Murray's out. Okay, well, that's true. But if your team is measurably, like, loses more games the next year, then you didn't have as good of a... Anyway.
Yeah.
But statistically, he has always been superior to everyone almost historically.
So MVP, will he win MVP again? He
like
will.
It's in the bag.
Because I would have thought Jason Tatum would also have a run at it. No.
You know, it's...
this will be 3 in a row?
Not in a row. Embiid won last year.
Oh, Embiid won. So
3 total.
3 of the last
3
4.
Of the 4.
Yeah.
I think Embiid was on the... Embiid was going to go back-to-back, but then he got hurt. So he doesn't meet the game's...
Right, right. He doesn't hit the 65.
And I also think there's a little feeling like... It was... I don't want to say... Okay, last year was a weird year. I felt like because of the way Jokic plays, and then he hadn't won yet, and... He's not that physical specimen like Giannis is or whatever it is. He doesn't necessarily pass the eye test, right?
Yeah.
And there's this thought, if he wins 3 in a row, which is what he would have won last year,
right?
Then you're in some rarefied air.
Like, sure.
Should he be in the same air as other guys who've won 3 in a row or, you know, that level of, even just 3 total? And I think that the last month of the season, it got, that MVP race last year was yucky.
Yeah.
Remember, it got racial and it got
weird. Oh, yeah, that was weird, yeah.
And even at the end, I think it was not fun for either guy because they actually are friends. Embiid and Jokic are friends and they like each other. And Jokic said this after one of the playoff games. It was like one of the games against the Lakers. And he just said he actually felt bad for Joel that he had to hear this all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like Embiid had one of his worst months of the season
right
in April as Denver was going into the playoffs. And it was almost, I don't want to say he threw it. He didn't throw the race or anything
right.
like that. But I felt like Embiid had a 60-point game on a night when Jokic had like 9 turnovers and they lost the game. And that sort of swung the race at the end. And it was like he won. And then Denver went on to win the championship. And everybody was like, you know what? You got to give that guy his flowers.
Sure.
Like, he really is the best player.
He is.
And it's translated to winning now.
Yeah.
Like when you've won 2 and you haven't won a championship, the threshold to win that third is higher. But now he's won a championship, and I almost it's like he's underappreciated.
He is. Vegas has him a heavy favorite. Like, he's going to win.
It's going to be in Jokic 1, Shea Gilgeous-Alexander 2, Luka Doncic 3. I can almost guarantee you those will be the top three.
Vegas has Luka 2, Shea 3, yeah, and Tatum 4.
Okay. I think Shea will be 2, but it depends on where they finish.
Right.
Yeah.
Worst MVP ever.
What is he talking about?
Worst take ever. All right.
Yeah.
Coming up next, we're going to do some Game of Games. Momo, it is your game today.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll see.
And you don't know.
I mean, it's definitely going to be better than the Central Asian Republic trivia I was doing.
Yeah, I don't know what you were thinking. That was not
going
to fly.
Going down a weird road.
Yeah. All right. So, you know,
I was doing questions about the Silk Road. I was like, oh,
yeah. Okay. So, you know, I'm a gambling fool. I love playing poker. And the only place I ever play is Commerce Casino. I got to get out there. I haven't been in 2 weeks out to play poker. Commerce Casino and Hotel is the largest poker room in the world. There is no bigger one. And there's no better place to play in SoCal. There's always a seat for you at the Commerce, maybe even right next to me. The poker action never ends. Get this. This year alone, the Commerce Casino is going to pay out over $20 million in jackpots. And whenever you go to the Commerce, great food, amazing staff, beautiful hotel rooms if you stay out there, daily tournaments, and of course the Commerce Casino and Hotel is the home for Mandy's 3 coming up this June. Commerce Casino, 6131 Telegraph Road in Commerce. For more information, visit commercecasino.com. That's commercecasino.com, and I'll see all you guys at the Commerce. Mason, Ireland, 710 ESPN.
710 ESPN.
And it is time for Game of Games on the number one sports radio show in L.A., Mason and Ireland.
Game of Games.
Game of Games presented by CallJacob.com.
Call Jacob.
Everyone loves a fighter, but in this town, winning matters, especially after an accident. So remember, anyone can fight, but CallJacob.com is here for you when you need a big win. After an accident, go to CallJacob.com or call 844-24-JACOB. That's 844-24-JACOB. We got the jingle.
Call Jacob.
Thank you. Game of Games time. Take it away, Mace.
All right, here we go. It is Game of Games time, and the whole afternoon show for today is here to play. Andy Kamenetsky and DeMarco Farr. What's
all
up, guys?
All of the afternoon drive show.
Everybody ready to roll here? Yeah,
Laura's here, too.
Oh, is Laura here also?
Yep.
All right,
yeah.
So Bergman, you're keeping score. It's going to be complex.
Oh, boy. I got six players. Mace, Greg, AK, DeMarco, Laura, Brian.
Perfect.
Just got nervous.
All right, and it's Momo's game.
Get nervous.
All right. Okay, I don't know if this is going to be good.
Good.
We'll see.
Yeah.
All right. It's one of those games.
Oh, it's your game?
It's my game.
We call those
sometimes,
your games.
Yeah. No, I've improved dramatically, but this one
what
might not.
What if I told you?
Yeah. I have improved dramatically. This might not be...
Last time she did a game, you know what afterwards she said?
I just will try to make them not suck next time.
Yeah. So, this is the test.
I was just lacking inspiration, and every inspiration I had was weird.
Yeah.
So
okay.
I landed on this one.
All right.
You were the inspiration, Steve.
Thank
Mason,
you.
Because you are trying to undergo a radical body transformation by the time you hit your big
60th
60.
Birthday, yeah.
All right.
And I was thinking that a lot of actors and actresses do this as well, so I'm going to read you some radical transformations that actors have made for their roles, and you tell me if it's true or false.
Okay,
okay?
Got it.
Some of these are true. Some of these are just some of the details are, well, you know,
yeah,
you get
right,
the
exactly.
idea. Okay. Charlize Theron has undergone multiple transformations. She gained 70 pounds to play a serial killer in 2003's Monster, but said she was able to lose most of it within 6 months by intermittent fasting for all but 6 hours a day. Is that true or false, Mason?
I'm going to say true.
Andy?
False.
Okay. DeMarco?
I'll say false.
Greg?
True.
And Brian?
False.
And Romo? Romo playing too?
Yep. I am going with true.
The correct answer is false.
Oh. Yeah.
She did lose. She did gain some weight, but that whole intermittent fasting thing.
And that was made up.
And she didn't gain 70 pounds.
No,
it's 70 pounds a lot.
It's a great movie. She got ugly and won the Oscar.
Right, wait. There's a lot of people. AK got that.
I know, it's
DeMarco
just a lot.
Got that.
Yeah.
Brian got
that. Yep, I got that.
Okay.
It's a scary movie.
Mace, Greg, and Laura did not.
Correct.
Okay.
Okay. Colin Farrell is one of Hollywood's handsomest men, but he had to cover his jawline under layers of prosthetics for his turn as Oswald Cobblepot, a.k.a. the Penguin, in 2022's The Batman. It took 3 hours every day to turn him into the villain, but the effort paid off as Farrell was disguised so well, he went into Starbucks incognito during filming.
Mm.
Is that true or false, Andy?
False.
DeMarco.
True.
Greg.
True.
Laura.
True.
And Brian.
False.
And then Mace.
True.
That is absolutely true.
Yeah.
Went into the Starbucks.
Greg.
Isn't that weird?
Part of the buildup, yeah.
You can't go into a Starbucks as the Penguin
incognito. You can go as a guy with a fat chin.
All right. Yeah. So
Greg needs help.
Yeah, let's... there's a lot of people.
Everybody simmer down.
Okay.
So simmer down and help
simmer down now.
Okay. Right.
Mace got that.
Yep.
Greg got that. AK. Did not get that.
I did not.
DeMarco got that.
Yes.
Laura got that. Brian?
Did not.
Okay.
All right. Honor system.
Thank you.
Okay. Matthew McConaughey lost 50 pounds to play Ron Woodruff in 2013's Dallas Buyers Club, which won him his first Oscar by eating just one meal a day and working out 5 times a week with his trainer. Is that true or false? DeMarco?
True.
Greg?
I'm going to say true also.
Laura?
I'm going to say false.
Brian?
False.
And Mace?
True.
And Andy?
True.
That is false.
Oh.
So that means that it's Laura and Brian got
What's
that
false
one.
About yep. it?
He didn't lose the weight by eating one meal a day.
Oh, okay. Yeah. He did lose the weight.
Yeah, he
oh,
wasn't 50
I see.
Pounds.
So you're throwing in little wrinkles.
Yeah. Like
oh,
very yeah. small,
a lot of technicalities.
I see. Gotta really, yeah, gotta really look though. For it.
When the word's if, that's not always true.
Challenging.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Who got it?
Brian,
I have no
Brian
idea.
And Laura. I'm starting to write down
okay.
the TF
okay.
for them.
Brian and Laura.
So it's
okay.
Brian 2, Laura 2,
You really
two,
have to
DeMarco
listen to
two,
what I say.
AK 1, Greg 1, Mace 1.
Okay. Renee Zellweger's first brush with physical transformation came with Bridget Jones's Diary in 2001. She famously gained 30 pounds to play the title character, but the hubbub over her still very average-sized body seems comical now. In 2022, she underwent a much more noticeable change for the NBC miniseries The Thing About Pam, in which she controversially wore prosthetics in a padded suit to appear overweight. Is that true or false? We start with Greg.
True.
Laura.
That was a lot, but I'm going to go false.
Brian?
True.
Mace?
I'm going to say this one's true.
Andy?
True.
And DeMarco.
That sounds true.
Yeah, that's all true.
All true.
So that's
true.
Everybody but me.
She wore the fat suit. Yeah.
Yeah.
People didn't like it.
Actually, it was a good. It was a really entertaining show.
Okay. Gary Oldman won an Oscar for his 2017 performance as Winston Churchill in The Darkest Hour after gaining 50 pounds to play the role in order to avoid having to spend 4 hours a day in makeup. Is that true or false, Laura?
False.
Brian?
True.
Mace?
I'm going to go true.
Andy?
False.
DeMarco?
I'll go true.
And
I'm going true
Greg.
Also.
That is false. He totally did not gain any weight for that. It was all prosthetics.
He wore a fat suit?
Yep.
Yeah.
Just AK and Laura got that one. So right now we have Laura 3, DeMarco 3, Andy 3, Mace, Greg, and Brian. Oh, no. Brian has 3 also.
I never saw that.
So 3, 3, 3, 2, 2.
2-2. Okay.
Okay. Jennifer Aniston stopped working out for 2 months to gain weight for 2014's movie Cake, in which she played a not-so-glamorous woman named Claire. She also went completely without makeup for the role, which earned her a Golden Globe and a Screen Actors Award nomination. Is that true or false? We start with Brian.
False.
Mace?
True.
Andy?
True.
DeMarco?
True.
Greg?
True.
And Laura?
False.
The answer is true. Yeah. Oh, that is true.
Right, so
no makeup for Jennifer Aniston.
Very brave,
Mace,
Momo.
Yeah. Greg, brave. AK, and DeMarco.
Everybody
got that
but Brian and Laura.
Yeah.
Demi Moore actually gained weight for her role in 1997's G.I. Jane.
G.I. Jane!
Because she needed a good amount of muscle to play convincingly.
Don't make
a military
any G.I.
officer.
Jane jokes in here. No G.I. Jane jokes.
But she
no one out your mouth!
But she refused to shave her head, preferring to wear a wig every day rather than spend months trying to grow her hair back after filming. Is that true or false? We are back around to... Are we on Brian or Mace?
No, Mace.
Mace.
False.
All right, Andy?
I think that is true.
DeMarco.
So she wore a wig in the movie.
In other words, she wore a skin cap kind
right.
of thing? Yeah.
Full cap.
Oh, that's full false. Cap. Yeah, false.
Okay. Greg?
I'm saying that it's... Wait, no, it's... She did not. False. False, false, false.
Okay. Laura?
False.
Brian?
False.
And Mace, you started with?
He said false.
I started with, no, I...
You
yeah,
said false.
I started with false.
Okay.
Yeah.
The answer is false. She totally shaved her head.
You're combining the Anna Taylor-Joy
thing.
That
was a big deal.
Yeah.
For the new Fury.
Yeah.
Okay, well, give us a score check, Bergman.
Okay. It is DeMarco 5, Mace 4, Greg 4, AK 4, Laura 4, Brian 4.
All right.
How many are left?
Two left.
Two left.
So DeMarco has to go first.
DeMarco goes first.
All right. Anne Hathaway lost so much weight, 25 pounds in about 6 weeks, to play Fantine in the 2012 big screen adaptation of Les Miserables, that she fainted on set during the first day of filming. It was worth it, though. She won a Best Supporting Actress Oscar for her work. Is that true or false, Andy?
DeMarco.
No, start with DeMarco.
Oh, DeMarco.
I'll go true. That sounds true.
Okay, then we go back to
Mace.
I need to make a point, but I think this is true.
Okay.
Andy? False.
Brian?
Brian?
False.
I have no idea what order I just called.
It's all right. I got it. Okay. I got it. I'm going to say...
so many people.
I am going to say it is true. And Laura?
I'm going to go with... four, right?
Yeah, you're just one back. You don't have to go with it.
Okay,
you can do whatever you want.
I'm going to go with false.
False. Okay, what is it, Momo?
The answer is false. She didn't faint on set.
So AK,
she
Laura,
didn't lose weight for
and
the role.
Brian got
she
did
lose weight, but not, she didn't faint on set.
She didn't faint? Dang.
That's what got me. That's what I was like.
Okay, Bergman, tell me who's still in this.
All right, we're all still in it. Everybody's still alive, but you and I, Mace, have to go opposite. Of AK, DeMarco, Laura, and Brian. They all have 5. We have 4.
Got it.
Okay. Hilary Swank added 19 pounds of muscle to play boxer Maggie Fitzgerald in 2004's Million Dollar Baby. She gained most of that weight by drinking egg whites with every meal because she could never eat enough eggs in any particular setting. Quote, it was just the worst thing ever.
Okay.
It was a success. She took home the Oscar for that role. Is that true or false?
I got it. Andy.
Ugh, that sounds disgusting. I'm going to say true.
True. Right. Laura.
I'm also going true.
Brian.
False.
And then we're out, Mace.
We're out.
DeMarco.
I'll say true.
Okay, so what's the answer?
The answer is true.
Yeah!
So Brian, do you have a tiebreaker?
Yeah, I do.
Okay,
I do.
So Andy, by the way, DeMarco and Laura are still alive on the tiebreaker.
Okay, and by the way, you're listening to KSPN Los Angeles, a Good Karma Branch radio station.
Thank you.
How much weight did Joaquin Phoenix lose to play the Joker?
Oh,
okay. So just come
Andy
up with a number.
Or I'm sorry, Andy and DeMarco.
No, it's Andy, DeMarco, and Laura. So Laura, you go first here. How much did he lose?
I put 30 pounds.
We're just going to go close.
You put 35.
30 pounds.
30 pounds. DeMarco.
42.
42, okay. Andy.
43.
Ooh.
Closest, not closest without going over.
Andy's the winner.
Yeah!
52 pounds.
Andy gets the W.
52
pounds.
Good job.
Nice. Wow. Andy Kamenetsky
wins.
That's
a lot of weight. That's a lot of weight.
A ton of weight. Yeah.
Wow.
Good game, too bad.
No, it was good game. I thought that was a pretty good game.
I wrote a lot of stuff in there.
Good game. Yeah,
nice.
Yeah,
good making game. It works. Random details.
Thumbs up. Absolutely.
Thumbs
hey,
up, Ish.
Let's do a little super crosstalk.
AM 710 Los Angeles.
KRDC AM 1110 Pasadena, Los Angeles.
K256CX 99.1 FM Pasadena, Los Angeles.
It's the greatest segment in LA sports radio history. Radio
history. Oh, my God.
When the shows come together for magic on the radio.
It will only grow stronger. Super Crosstalk.
Are we ready for Sedano and Kaff to join Mason in Ireland?
Super Crosstalk begins.
Super Crosstalk. Presented by Coors Light. Coors Light. Made to chill.
It's time for Super
So, no Love Boat today.
No Love Boat.
No Love Boat. DeMarco's here.
What's happening?
Andy Kamenetsky's here.
Hey.
Momo's here.
Yeah.
A little super cross talk.
Why'd you just fall over again when you do that?
What do you mean?
The woo-woo. You fall over when you do that.
Because I don't want to do woo-woo right
into
the microphone.
Into the mic. That's
so
what
I
it was.
Pull away from the microphone a little bit. It's a broadcastery
thought
thing.
You were
that
going
I thought you know what? That's why you're in the Hall of Fame.
Very, very broadcastery.
Thought you were going down for a minute there.
Yeah, no, yeah. No.
Not.
So you heard Momo do the weather, right?
Incredible.
Yeah.
Just off the top of my head.
I feel like I know exactly what's happening. I know what I'm going to drive home to.
Yeah.
I know what it's going to be like tomorrow.
This is what I texted Momo, like in real time,
in real time,
all caps. That is a effing weather report,
see?
Momo.
Wow.
There you
three
go.
Exclamation points.
All caps and three exclamation points.
I was just kind of born for this, right?
You were born for it. I don't know
how
you got stuck.
I just came out the womb. Like,
how did you get stuck doing the NBA when you could be doing
weather?
The weather.
Wow. That's awesome.
I mean, there's almost nothing. There's almost nothing I like better than looking at the radar.
But it would be interesting.
I mean, like,
weirdo. Looking at radar?
Wouldn't you like to change jobs for one day? Just one day. You and somebody doing the weather change jobs one day.
I mean, I literally will check the radar before I drive to see what time I should leave my house because that cell's going to come over.
By the way, all this stuff, and you were of no help the day we played pickleball in the rain.
I know.
They kept saying.
You did not enlist me.
You know, that's a good point, man.
You need
they
to.
They kept saying,
great
no,
point.
At 10:30, there's going to be a window.
You know what? Here's the thing. I think I just needed to be empowered. Like, if you would have said to me early in the week, Momo, you're on the weather. There's a chance of rain.
Right.
And we need to have hourly forecasts,
right,
so that we can plan what time everyone to show up to this event.
Yeah,
because if we would have started the event at noon, we'd have been fine.
Well, would it have been
fine?
It
was fine
right
by
when
noon.
We left, it cleared up.
Yeah,
it did.
Yeah,
I drove home and it was sunny.
Yeah, cleared up. Wow,
it was very disappointing.
You
need to be empowered. I thought this is who you are.
No, you just had like Morales
Take
or Tommy
control.
Needed to say to me, "Hey, I know you're really good at the weather. I need you to, this is an important thing for us. Can you just really babysit this?"
You were dead serious when you said you were the weather girl for your softball
yes.
team.
Yeah.
My coach like gave me this job.
Mm.
This was like a very, he would look a little bit, but he knew that I was going to get in there and study it.
Right.
Like, and this is before cell phones and text messages and stuff.
Oh, sure.
So, I mean,
you had like a big map at home with a low pressure button on it.
No, I would just go home and turn on the TV in my dorm room and watch the Weather Channel, and it would do the local forecast, and I would watch how the radar went. I'd be like, okay, that's going ahead at about 6 o'clock.
Yeah.
All right, we need to do that. And then I would check it throughout the day, and if things change, like, so I was conservative. Like, if I wasn't sure, I was like, we got to put the tarp on, guys.
Right.
Wow.
Right.
I never check weather. Not once.
I never. I hear when there's a storm. Like, oh, yeah, there's a storm and everybody's all, you know,
you get an alert,
cats
and, you know,
and dogs, yeah, yeah, and Spectrum interrupts everything and says, yeah, there's a flash flood warning for someplace. I don't know where,
yeah,
it is.
How bad could it be here?
Yeah,
yeah. You know what I mean?
It's exactly been a lot of rain.
Yeah,
rain,
it is.
Yeah,
we've had more rain the last 2 years than like ever.
But not like tornadoes. Like,
there's, yeah, not even, you know, a drought anymore.
Yeah, yeah.
Like we had a historic drought and it's over.
It's over. Yeah. We're good.
We're floating.
That's
now
enough.
That's enough.
That's plenty. We're full up.
No more rain.
But it's, I guess it's supposed to rain tomorrow?
Is it, yeah, it's a 35% chance.
Is it really?
It, but okay, it's mostly just going to be really cold.
Okay.
Do you have sound of that? I want to hear your weather report.
I could do it again.
You can? No.
No?
No.
We'll go back and listen to it on the podcast.
It was amazing.
It was great. But I mean, you'll never capture it live the way you, okay, did earlier. So listen to it on the podcast. No, it's not necessary.
Mace is good. He's, yeah, like, I've heard you do the weather before.
I heard the forecast. I know. So I'm going to get a colonoscopy tomorrow.
Oh, my God.
I just,
bro,
had mine within the last year.
With the, and it's, did, well, how was the,
how much
preparation?
Weight did you lose?
It's not really a weight,
well,
loss,
I mean, yeah,
technique, is it?
That's, I mean, a colonic, isn't it?
I mean,
it's a colonic.
There are some people who undergo colonoscopy prep as a weight loss,
yeah,
thing.
Do they?
Oh yeah, diuretics.
Oh, that's gotta be, that's gotta be very unhealthy.
I mean, yeah, it's, I'm not recommending,
hey,
it.
Listen,
just saying,
when you were trying to make that goal weight,
yeah,
you're with your bet, that's,
yeah,
absolutely what you should have done the night before.
Oh, just like pretend there's a colonoscopy tomorrow.
Just,
yeah,
flush it out.
Yeah.
Wow.
You're, yeah, like a boxer. Grab some Miralax. Let's,
absolutely,
go.
What, yeah, was your goal weight? What were you trying to hit?
Well, what I'm going to hit ultimately is 185. I'm about,
ooh,
193 right now.
185. Okay.
Yeah, that's 185, so, is the number.
You're in the neighborhood.
That's lean and mean. Yeah.
But I'm also, I mean, I'm hitting the gym. Like yesterday was leg day.
Yeah.
I'm really sore. I'm working with this trainer guy who actually trained Christian Bale for the Batman movies.
Okay.
Trains Michael Keaton. Trained, I don't know if you've
Does
seen this
train
movie.
Any other Batman?
I think that's, oh, right, he's got two Batman.
Does he train Pattinson? Does he train Clooney?
Oh, that's right, he's got two Batman. I never thought of that before.
Mark Hamill.
Yeah, right. And he also, there's this actress named Lily O'Brien who's playing Katie O'Brien, who's playing a bodybuilder in this movie called Love Lies Bleeding.
I've heard it's good.
He did her train. So my goal is, on my 60th birthday, I'm going to sit here with my shirt off and do the show.
Wow.
That's your goal.
That's my goal.
I like it.
Yeah.
Have you already mapped out if your 60th falls on a weekday?
You know, I've not gone that far. I've not gone that
You'll
far.
Be okay,
it probably,
right,
doesn't, because, yeah, it was a Saturday this year. Yeah.
By the way, I will be wearing my two chains.
You know what it
becomes? You wear two chains.
I wear two chains.
Okay.
Yeah.
That, you know, that could be like your radio name.
Falls on a
Two chains?
Steve Two Chains Mason.
Yeah. I like it.
Falls on a Saturday? Sabado y Gante.
Exactly. Exactly.
So I have a warning for you, though. When you start working out really hard,
yeah,
you're going to want to eat more.
Yeah, I'm not doing that.
It's going to make you hungry.
I'm not in for that.
So if you eat more, you have to eat just healthy stuff. You have to just like buy a bunch of chicken.
Yeah, chicken breast and brown rice.
Yeah. What
and
was
broccoli.
Your leg day? What'd you do? Squats?
Squats and presses and calves.
Yeah, oh, you're good and sore.
Yeah, I'm super sore.
I can't wait to see you walk out
why
of the room.
Why is it the day? Now, I'm sore from my upper body workout this week, but that was on Tuesday. Last night, I'm not quite super sore yet. Why does it take a day to get sore?
That lactic acid buildup.
Is that what it is?
And then you go to sleep and you wake up.
If you want to not be, if you want to not be sore, you go in the hot cold.
Ah.
Because that flushes
is that
the
right?
lactic acid
out.
You do like a.
Have you tried a cold plunge before?
I haven't tried. I've tried cryo.
So you can go, but the best is like if you have a jacuzzi and a cold pool.
Yeah.
So you can do the jacuzzi and then the cold shower.
Well, I do have a jacuzzi, as famously
you go back
Morales
and,
wants
to get
into. But
you have
to
go back and forth. You have to go cold and then hot.
What
cold,
time
hot.
Is your colonoscopy?
11 a.m. tomorrow.
Okay, because I was going to say, because it's in the
you
morning.
You want to say a prayer while it happens? 11 a.m. everybody.
I'm
going to
do that on my own time.
Hold a conscious thought for me.
But because of the prep. Yeah. You're going to have to wake up probably in the middle of the night to drink
correct.
The second
you do
part
have
of this.
To drink the second so the, part of the Kool-Aid.
The good news is you're not going to actually be able to sleep because you're not going to be able to get comfortable,
right.
which will keep your muscles from
getting
stiff.
So, right.
So this
good
actually is
plus
good.
It's all Gatorade.
Mm-hmm.
It's the blue flavor.
Yeah.
Nobody really knows what the blue it's called Cool Ice. Nobody really knows what flavor that is.
Cool Ice.
Cool
I thought
Ice.
It was Cool nice. Blue, man.
Is, it,
cool
is that what it is? Cool
I
blue.
It was cool blue. Yeah.
What's it, ta-
it was
what's
Arctic
it taste
ice.
Like?
It is Arctic ice.
Arctic ice.
Yeah.
Is it Arctic ice?
Is that
I thought
a,
like,
they may
like
be different flavors.
Yeah.
But I know like red is
cherry. I don't know what blue is.
It's like blue raspberry.
Blue raspberry.
Like the red slushy. Is fruit punch. The white is the cherry.
Yeah,
you're not supposed to drink cherry. The red.
No.
You're not supposed to.
The red
to
is banned.
Why? Why is the red bad?
So then when they put the camera up there, they everything's not all red.
Okay. Yeah, because there's a lot of infrared. Red in your innards.
Yeah, yeah.
Infrared. Yeah.
What are you guys going today?
Oh, more colonoscopy talk.
Are you going to do
definitely
an hour?
I mean, listen,
my colonoscopy.
You chose more colonoscopy talk over another weather report.
I wanted to hear the weather. He, yeah.
I mean, yeah. I can do some talk talk too.
Yeah, yeah, talk
you want
talk.
Some talk talk?
Yeah.
Yeah. I bring the content.
All right, everybody. I am gone till the 15th.
Wow.
Nice, Mies.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Are you off the grid?
No.
Okay.
No, I will not be off the grid.
So I can make a fantasy baseball trade?
I will make fantasy baseball trades. I'm not making any pretense of being off the grid. Good. And I'm speaking of my alma mater next week.
Oh, no kidding.
Oh, yeah. That's awesome. Wow.
All right. I got to come up with stuff to say. Smart stuff.
You're a Hall of Famer.
You're a Hall of Famer. Yeah. You're going to be fine, sir.
No, I told him, I said, I'm going to think up smart stuff for this.
Nice.
And they were like.
And if you start choking, just do the weather.
There you go.
Serious. You can just go up there and be like, just off the top of your head.
Yeah.
Everybody finds
okay.
it.
Okay. Momo, fun working with you today.
Before you leave, did you ever get your huge birthday card that's in the studio?
No.
It's like right here. Your face is on
Where
it
is
and
it?
Everything.
I never got
Hold
it.
Hold on. I know. I was like, why is it full? I got you. Hold on.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't realize I had a big
we
birthday
all signed
card
it.
With my face on it.
We all like, signed it. It was good.
Didn't everybody sign it? I never even saw it.
I didn't get a chance to sign it.
It's because it was raining and
stuff.
Yeah,
everybody
good Lord, look at the size of that card.
Yeah. That's gigantic.
That's the biggest card I've ever seen.
Yeah, that is.
Here.
How does that make you feel to have a card like that?
Makes me feel very
special. Look,
makes me feel special. Yeah, special.
Look at the size of the.
Oh yeah, that's impressive.
Look at your face.
Wow.
Great.
Yeah, no, that's a good shot right there. I got the Superman glasses on. The Clark Kent glasses.
Right over your bed.
Yeah, I'm gonna put it on the ceiling right over the bed. The ceiling.
Every morning you wake
up
seeing your favorite person.
Exactly. All right. Hey, have a great week. I will be back on the 15th. In the meantime, Ireland is back tomorrow, and I think it's here next week. You're doing a couple of shows, too.
Yeah.
Coming up next for you, afternoon, Shadano and Cap today is Andy Kamenetsky and DeMarco Farr. See you soon, 7:30.